Hanover Wildcat football coverage on KCLY is brought to you in part by Kramer Oil, Andy's Hardware and Lumber of Hanover, Marysville Livestock, Hanover Electric, Ray's Apple Market, Floyd's Repair Hanover, TSI Kansas Incorporated Clay Center, the Citizen State Bank of Hanover, Waterville, and Marysville, and Oldie Seed Farms.
It's two teams with two different histories meeting in the eight-man Division II state championship game today at Newton Fisher Field. The Hanover Wildcats are making their seventh championship appearance, while their opponent, the Dighton Hornets, are making their first appearance in school history. Hanover, coached by Matt Hoyer, is 11-0, and the Wildcats are making their third straight championship game appearance after finishing runner-up the last two seasons in Division I, which includes last year's 62-16 loss to Spearville. The Wildcats have won three titles in school history, in 79 in 2A, and they went back-to-back in 2008 and 2009 in Division II. Hanover punched their ticket to the championship last Friday with a 48-0 victory over Pike Valley. The Wildcats' other two playoff wins came against St. John's Tipton 38-12 and Hutch Central Christian 62-16. The Dighton Hornets, coached by Ken Simon, they're 12-0, and they punched their ticket with a 40-32 victory over Wallace County. The Hornets' other playoff victories are against Lakeside, down 62-8, and Chase 51-6. Hello, everyone. My name is Trent Sanchez. Alongside my partner, Tim Klein, our studio engineer for today's game is Bernie Fancella. We thank you for joining us for Hanover Wildcats State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9. Well, Coach Klein, thank you for being with me once again.
You bet, Trent.
What's cool about this, we are the only show in the state right now. There's no, we're 13 and a half minutes looking at the scoreboard. 13 and a half minutes away from kickoff. This is the only game taking place, and of course there will be another eight-man game a little bit later, but spotlights on eight-man football today with 11-man playing yesterday in the semifinals.
Exactly. That's what it's all about. It's great to be here. An eight-man setup is cool because they get their own Saturday, and they get their own show, and they get their own place to play.
By the way, the other championship game taking place today here at Fisher Field at 3:30, it's going to be Osborne. Osborne is 12-0. And they're going to be taking on St. Francis. St. Francis beat Spearville last week, so it's going to be Osborne 12-0 against St. Francis 11-0, and that game will kick at 3:30. We're going to take a time out, and I'll be back and tell you about what happened last night in 11-man football throughout the state of Kansas right here on KCLY 100.9.
At Sapp Brothers, they pride themselves on the high level of service they provide and their ability to meet their customers' special fueling needs. From bulk gasoline and diesel to propane and oil delivery, Sapp Brothers is a fuel source to residents and businesses alike in Marshall and Washington counties. They can deliver a variety of bulk fuels to where you need it, at your home or out in the field. Contact them for a competitive fuel quote. Call their Hanover office at 337-2446.
When you need maintenance service or repair for your vehicle, how can you be sure you're choosing a professional repair facility? One you can count on for excellent service, integrity, and dependability. One way is to visit Floyd's Auto Repair, an auto-valued service center. They offer complete general automotive repairs and represent the best of the best with top quality parts and reliable certified techs. From a simple oil change to engine overhauls, rely on Floyd's Auto Repair, your auto value service center in Hanover.
The Hanover Hospital and Warren Clinic is ready to protect your family's health care needs. From newborns to seniors and everyone in between, they are committed to delivering high quality care. Addressing the health needs ranging from prevention, checkups, and care of illnesses and injury to maternity and other health conditions, they take pride in those they serve. Join Hanover Hospital and Warren Clinic in cheering on the student athletes of the community in their academic and sporting events. They're proud of the Hanover Wildcats.
BNW Electric in Hanover is your local electrical specialist, and they're ready to meet your residential or commercial needs. They can handle rewiring jobs, installations, new construction, and more. Rest assured, the work will get done right the first time by professionals who know the job. BNW Electric is ready to handle any project that requires a backhoe. Keep them in mind for all your electrical needs and backhoe service. BNW Electric, proud fans and huge supporters of the Hanover Wildcats.
And welcome back to Fisher Field here in Newton. Trent Sanchez alongside my partner, Tim Klein, as we're getting ready for Hanover State Championship football here on KCLY. Just taking a glance on what took place last night. We'll jump first to Class 6A. It was Blue Valley beating Shawnee Mission East in overtime. That's the game we were wondering about. That went overtime. Blue Valley won 35-34. Derby beat Lawrence Free State 49-21. So it's Blue Valley and Derby, both undefeated. Next week in 6A in Emporia. In 5A, Mill Valley beat Aquinas 14-13. Goddard beat Great Bend 50-21. So next Saturday in 5A in Pittsburgh, it's going to be Mill Valley 8-4 against Goddard 11-1. 4A Division 1, it was Bishop Miege beating Baser Linwood 52-0. Buehler beating Mays South 27-7. And so those two will play. Miege undefeated, Buehler 11-1 at Hummer Sports Park in Topeka next Saturday. In Salina next Saturday, it's going to be Hayden and Pratt. Hayden beat Holton last night 20-8. Pratt over Holcomb 21-14. Hayden 8-4. Pratt 11-1. In 3A, it was Rossville over Nemaha Central 27-22. Heston over Hoisington 35-19. So those two, Rossville 12-1, Heston 10-3. They'll play at Gowan Stadium in Hutch next Saturday.
That's probably the surprise of the night right there with Hoisington and Heston.
Yeah, Heston really came on at the end of the year. In 2-1A, it was Troy beating Pittsburgh Colgan 28-0. Plainville over Smith Penner 14-0. So Troy undefeated against Plainville 11-1. That's going to be at Lewis Field in Hayes next Saturday. And then, of course, we have the two eight-man games today. So let's take a closer look at these two teams. Folks probably want to know about Dighton. This is the first meeting between these two teams in school history. This Dighton football team, they're coached by Ken Simon in his sixth year. And Coach Simon, he's originally from Argonia, graduated there in 2002, went to play football at Dodge City, didn't work out for him, so he went on and got his degree at Fort Hays State University. He was an assistant for 3 years before taking over the Dighton program. Last year, they were just 5-4, didn't even make the playoffs last year, and here they are in their first state championship in school history. So several firsts, first meeting between these two schools, first state championship appearance for Dighton in school history. They're 12-0 on the season. They're out of the Northwest Kansas League. This is the league that you know about, Coach, because you used to coach Hoxie in basketball. The teams in it, Hoxie, Atwood, Rollins County, Oberlin, Decatur Community, Quinter, Sharon Springs, Wallace County, St. Francis, and Tribune, Greeley County. And somehow, they avoided playing St. Francis.
Right. That's because the way league was set up and the way the regional brackets were set up also. Well, St. Francis is a D1.
But I mean during the regular season, right. They didn't even play it.
Right.
So that's what I'm talking about. Because when you look at their strength of schedule, and not to take anything away from them, we can just go through their season, and it was rather lopsided. They beat a winless Quinter team to start the year, 54-0. Week 2 beat Decatur Community, 48-0. They ended up 2-6. Wichita County in Week 3, 49-0. They ended up 5-4. One on the road at Northern Valley. And by the way, when they beat Decatur Community, that was on the road. They won at Northern Valley in Week 4, 68-18. They ended up 4-5. Week 5 beat Tri-Plains Brewster 74-14. They ends up 1-8. They only played one playoff team in the regular season. That was at Wallace County. Beat them 42-32. Also beat them last Friday in the semis. Wallace County ended up 8-4. And then we move ahead to October the 14th. It defeated Otis Bison 36-30. They ended up 6-3. Then they beat Hodgman County, who's down this year, 58-8. Hodgman ended up 5-4 and wrapped up the regular season, week 9, at Greeley, Colorado, winning 50-0. Greeley, Colorado ended up 3-6. So Dighton's opponent's record on the year, 34-48. And again, their pathway to the championship, beat Lakeside 62-8, beat Chase 51-6, and then defeated Wallace County for a second time, 40-32, and in that game against Wallace County, had the big lead, Coach, but Wallace County was able to gain some ground late and make that score respectable there in the end and actually make it a very close game.
Yeah, actually, their scores were basically the same as Hanover since we were checking all the way along. Then all of a sudden, the second half, so Wallace County came back on them.
Some of the key players for this Dighton football team. It's Tyler Ling. We'll start right there with their quarterback. 6'5". He's a senior, 220 pounds. He has thrown for over 2,000 yards, 2,052 yards on the year, completed 74% of his passes, 43 touchdowns, four interceptions. I don't care if you're playing in the backyard, Coach. Those are big-time numbers, big time. His favorite target has been Dylan Foo, 78 catches, 1,230 yards receiving, 102.5 yards per game, 27 touchdown receptions. Their leading gainer on the ground, Lake Lewis. And Lake Lewis, he is the fullback, 89 carries, 700 yards, 7.9 yards per carry, 14 touchdowns on the season. And, you know, if I want to go ahead and jump to a key real quick, Coach, one thing that I think is a concern for Dighton, I think Hanover's a more balanced football team when you look at it. I think when I started looking at the numbers, it made me somewhat excited to see that they rely so heavily on the pass.
They do, and that's one thing that Dighton has really a detriment right now is that they only have 14 players out. Hanover has 25 out. Hanover's deeper. You can see that last week. You can get them with Will Brunner going down for a little while. Stoppomber came in and just went and scored touchdowns after that and really got better as the game went on. Dighton, on the other hand, they have about 8 players or so out of those 14 that are going to be the core. If any of those get injured, that's going to be tough. The other thing is they went to a full game last week and they were challenged. So, you know, them being in a full game, I think Hanover's been in a full game, they'll be fine.
Also, experience is going to factor in this contest, no doubt about it. I mentioned it, Dighton, this is their first ever state championship experience. Matter of fact, again, they weren't even in the playoffs last year. On the other hand, you have Hanover. This is their seventh state championship appearance. They're 3-3 in title games. They won it all in 79 in 2A that year over Douglas. Then they went back-to-back, of course, in Division II in 2008, 2009 against Victoria and Bushton Cavera Heights, respectively, in those 2 years. Runner-up the last 2 seasons in Division I, lost to Central Plains in 2014, and in 2015, last year, lost to Spearville. And also, they were runner-up in Division I back in 2007. But just the experience, Coach, three consecutive years now being in the state championship game for Hanover. And if you're Dighton, I mean, you've never even done this before. Heck, you weren't even in the playoffs last year.
No, and that's another thing is, too, you know, you look at league play. Dighton's league is, you know, I've been in both leagues. I've had the ability to be unfortunate to be in both leagues, the NWKL and also the Twin Valley League, also TVL. So, I mean, you talk about the competition level in both leagues. It's definitely in Hanover's favor.
So the coin toss taking place right now between these two teams, and I think the other thing that's a factor in this game as well, Coach, the key for Hanover is just the depth. Just the depth in this game. They have more players than Dighton does.
Definitely, and that's what I'd say to go back to that. Definitely, they have, you know, when you go with 25 players, you're going to have the ability to have more size and the ability to be more diverse in your offense, your defense, and, you know, even Hanover has enough players. They can live in platoons sometimes with their players. So
Dighton won the coin toss and they elect to receive?
Yes, that's right. That's right.
And the captains out there for Hanover, it was Adam Fritchie, Will Bruno, so great to see him back, and Adam Darbaniski.
And he's looking really good. Will looks very healthy. He looks ready to play. Of course, you know, I don't think there's probably the Clydesdales that would hold him off the field right now. Will Brennan, knowing his background, his competitiveness.
South?
East.
East, all right. So this field runs east and west, Coach. That's why I have you here, for those little things, Coach.
That's Western Kansas directional. Right there. My GPS growing up in Western Kansas, you know exactly where the directions are.
I let you drive, and we did about like a circle trying to get parked. I got a little bit confused. So the field will run west to east, so Dighton will receive the football, and they'll receive it out of the west end zone and defend that west end zone. Dighton, they are the Hornets. They're going to be in black uniforms. Look like Oregon State-type uniforms out there. Black uniforms, orange lettering and numbering trimmed in white. Hanover with their beautiful whites on today with blue numbering with red trim. Same for the lettering. And Hanover will kick off to start this football game. Kicking off of the Wildcats, it will be Carter Bruna. The sun is out. Game time conditions, 31 degrees. The wind out of the northwest at 9 miles per hour. The high stay expected to be 46. Back deep for Dighton, it is Dylan Foo.
Oh, they switched kickers on you, Trent.
They did. And now kicking off. Here is the kickoff for Hanover. That was Pete Peters. And Foo's running with the football at the right side. He's at the 40, and he goes down right at the 40-yard line. Now, I have to get used to these end zones, Coach, because this is on field turf, and they modified everything. He went down at the 30-yard line. Even though it says the 40, he went down at the 31.
Well, look at the orange markers along the side of the field. It's big numbers on the field. How about that?
A little bit confusing, but we're on top of it now. So they start at the Hanover 31-yard line. Tyler Ling, the quarterback, he's a big one. He'll swing it out to the far side. It's going to be caught by Foos. Foos in traffic, able to slip through a couple of defenders, finally goes down inside of the 30-yard line.
Now there's a swing pass to the left to the flat right there. It's a really good pass by Ling to start off the game, and then Foos actually has some really good speed. And Foos is a Western Kansas name, so.
That's a pass play of 4 yards, so it's going to be second down and six. Second and six here for the Dighton Hornets. Just underway. Dighton in black going left to right, west to east. Football on the far hash. Wing right formation. Handoff. Handover all over that. No gain on the play. Matter of fact, a loss. Carrying the football, that's their leading ground gainer, Lake Lewis.
Lake Lewis was just swarmed by this humanity from Hanover. I just see that this human pile just became him. So that was just a great play on the Hanover's part. And once again, it was led by their middle nose linebacker, Carlos Emanuel. He just stacked it up and plugged the hole.
Going to go down as no gain, so it's going to be third and six. The football at the Hanover 27-yard line. Twins right, single receiver to the left-hand side of the formation. Ling to throw the football, looking to his right. Dancing, turns right, makes the throw. Foos is wide open. Foos inside of the 15, going down inside of the 10-yard line.
Yeah, I don't know how he got that wide open. That's for sure. Stahlbomber's right there with him, and they're playing a zone defense. They might have to think about man-to-man, looks like, but Foos is wide open.
He is good. That is a great combination between those two. As Foos on the season again, 1,230 yards receiving coming into this football game. 15.8 yards per catch, 78 reception. So now it is first down and goal. The football is at the 10-yard line, just inside of the 10-yard line, and it's going to be a run play, and that is Foos getting it out of the backfield this time, and he manages just one. Just 1 yard on the game for Dylan Foos.
Now, they left with the right tackle that time, or right guard, excuse me, right through the, what's called the A-gap here on eight-man. And just basically just plowed it up in there, but Hanover was right there and plugged the hole. They're going to have a tough time running against Hanover. They just need to tighten up the Hanover's defensive pass defense.
So now it's second down and goal. The football at the 8-yard line. Lake Lewis to the right of the quarterback, Ling. Foos motioning to the far left wide side of the field. Ling looking to his left. Makes the throw. Foos is wide open. Puts on the brakes. And he gets ankle tackled. Fritchie did a good job. Adam Fritchie of holding on to his ankle for dear life. So he advances the football just inside of the 5 to the 4-yard line. So a gain of 4. Again, it's very confusing here because there's two sets of numbers basically out there to look at.
Well, now markers are down. That's the nice thing about it. We can tell whether it's inside the 10 or not. But that was just a great pass. So a flat pass on the right, on the left side there to Foos. But the nice thing was his footwork. He just stopped, made the tackle or miss, and luckily there's another tackle there for Hanover.
Third and goal at the 4-yard line of Hanover here for Dighton. Opening possession of the game. Just underway. Here is Ling throwing, and it's going to be incomplete as he was looking for David Kramer. Kramer being covered that time by Zarbaniski. Adam Zarbaniski in coverage.
Yeah, Zarbaniski was right there with him the whole way, and that was a great thing. In fact, he almost had an angle almost to pick it off and head towards six on the other end. Some great defense that time with Zarbaniski.
So now it is fourth down and goal at the 4-yard line. Football on the far hash. Lewis to the right of the Ling. Twins right. Foos in the slot here to the near right wide side of the field. Ling looking that way. Now looking middle, being flush. Gets out of trouble, running to his left. And he gets into the end zone with that tall frame. Fritchie had grabbed a hold of him, but he's just too big. He's 6'5", and he was able to lean across and break the plane for the score.
Yeah, that was just a great read on his part. The full pocket collapsed, but then there had to be a seam right there. He slipped right through the seam to the left, headed to the goal line, and just basically dived over the goal line when he saw it coming up so close.
So the quarterback, Tyler Ling, rushes for what is his 9th rushing touchdown of the season. The Dighton takes the early lead 6-0. Coach, and that's big for them, confidence-wise, in their first-ever appearance here.
It is. It's used. Kind of gets the jitters off, a little shake the nerves off a little bit of time.
Going for two. Booth all by himself here on the near right side. Three receivers set. Ling looking left. A man in his face. Pumps down, runs to his right. Fritchie got a hold of him, and he gets some help, and they bring him down, tackle him short of breaking the plane as Trevor Clip and others there in on that stop. But Dighton scores. They lead 6-0. It was their quarterback, Tyler Ling, with a 4-yard touchdown run at the 8:40 mark of quarter one. Hanover gets it for the first time. When we come back, you're listening to Hanover Football on KCLY 100.9.
Bruna Implement, your local Case IH dealer, is excited about the success of the area's high school athletes as they wind down the season. Watching them become not only better athletes, but better young men is the most rewarding thing to see. The love they have for the game, the commitment to the team, and the pride in their schools show in what they bring to the field. Congratulations to all the area high school teams making it to the postseason playoffs. Bruna Implement, your Case IH dealer, is extremely proud of you.
It's not too early to book your holiday party, so make out your guest list and set the date. Landau Lanes is the perfect place for your holiday party this year. Their conference center can accommodate small and large groups, whether it's a family get-together or a business event. You provide the guests and the party atmosphere. Landau Lanes will provide the venue and delicious food and drinks that you'll need for a fantastic party. Don't be naughty. Book your holiday party now at Landau Lanes in Marysville.
Logan Lane getting set to kick off for Dighton. They lead over Hanover 6-0, 8:40 to go here in the first quarter. Hanover getting set to get the football for the first time, and that kick going out of bounds, so Hanover will have their choice. Dighton with an impressive drive. It was Lane, the quarterback, with a 4-yard touchdown run. Six plays, 31 yards, and a time of 3:14. And I talked about them not having balance. Well, it ended up being a balanced drive for Dighton, as they had three running plays and three passing plays on that drive, and Hanover electing to have Dighton kick off the football again.
Yes, Brother Ling will kick the football off number 40. Got a cast on his right arm. So he'll kick off the ball again one more time for Dighton.
Fist in the air. And here's the approach and the kickoff. This one a knuckleball, and it's going to be fielded and picked up here by Thomas Atkins. Atkins starts to his right, working his way up the near boundary, and gets shoved out of bounds right at the 25-yard line. So that's where Hanover will start with the football. 8:34 to go here in quarter one. They trail 6-0. This is their first possession.
They're explosive on offense. They're very explosive on offense. So it's great to see their offensive team on the field right now, because this is where their heart and soul is, basically, with Hanover.
Hanover averaging just shy of 50 points per game, 49.7, and they're sure glad that Will Brunet is back at quarterback, went down with a rib injury in the first half last week, and that went over Pike Valley. Hanover with trips to the right side of the formation. It is going to be Bruna running off the right side. He gets a wall as he'll turn the corner and goes out of bounds at the 30-yard line. So a gain of 5 on first down for quarterback Will Bruna.
Yeah, he's pretty padded up, but he tell you what, he showed no fear there. He knew exactly what he's got to do, and he's got to lead this team, and he knows it for his third straight state championship appearance.
Well, last week, unofficially, I had him 10 carries, 125 yards, two touchdown runs, 1 of 3 yards, and then that one of 51 yards. He was so fast on that one. Second and 5 for Hanover. Football on the far hash at the 30-yard line. Out of the shotgun, here's a snap to Will Bruna looking to pass for the first time, and a flag down, and it's going to be a procedure penalty on the Wildcat. That's their first penalty.
In fact, that's the first penalty of the game, isn't it?
Well, you had the one on the kickoff.
Oh, that's true.
The crew, Devin Treister.
Yes.
Treister is the referee. Tom King, the umpire. The line judge, Scott Creer. Linesman is Jamie McClure. And Ron Tenbrink is the back judge today here in the state championship game.
We'll just line up for the area.
Second and 10 for Hanover at their own 25. Down 6-0. Here's a pass completed over the middle. Zarbitrisky, Brennan with the catch. And he goes down at the 30-yard line. Gets out actually past the 30-yard line. He'll take it to the 33. Third down coming up.
Five caught that.
Stahlbomber?
Yep.
All right. But Dakin Stahlbomber with that catch, so I beg your pardon. Numbers not too far apart.
Nope.
So it's going to be third down and 2. Third down and 2. The football at the 33-yard line. Bruna on the option. Makes the pitch. Dietrich with the football, and Dietrich gets strung out and taken down. Dylan Poo. Been mentioning that name a lot. He's frozen for a loss
back to the 31-yard line. A loss of two for Kevin Dietrich.
Yeah, they tried an option play right there to Dietrich. Of course, you know, that's usually your thunder, your lightning connection there with the Bruna and stuff, so, and Dietrich. So couldn't get quite the outside, so they're punting.
We'll see if they do punt. It is fourth down and four at the 31-yard line here for Hanover. No, they will punt it. And it is Will Bruna who punts the football, and it will just go into the end zone for a touchback. Boy, it about died at the one, but it just rolled in. So Hanover with a three and out on their first series. And, Coach, when you look back at it, the penalty.
Yeah, it was the penalty that killed that drive. Zabotrisky almost got that football before when the end zone. He just couldn't get his hand down low enough to tap it back.
So Dighton will have the football at the 15-yard line. They lead 6-0. 6-0, Dighton with the lead. Tyler Ling, a 4-yard touchdown run. That's the difference in this football game right now. Dighton in black going left to right. Again, like Oregon State-like colors to their uniform. Ling rolling to his right, looking downfield, makes the throw. It's going to be incomplete. Threw it behind his intended target. That was Dalton Hoffman. Hoffman plays in the backfield, but also out as a receiver. Couldn't catch that one. That's the first incompletion of the game for Dighton's Tyler Lane.
Yeah, Zarbonicki was right there also to make this play and push him out of bounds.
Starters for Dighton up front, you have David Kramer, Isaac Torsten, Gunther Scholl, Logan Ling, and Dylan Fu. Four of the five guys there, and that's in tight end to tight end. Four of the five guys there, returning starters. David Kramer, the only one that's not. Wing right formation, 2nd and 10 from the 15-yard line here for Dighton. Play fake. Ling to throw the football. Clean pocket. Throws it deep middle of the pass. Going to be intercepted. Picked off. Stahlbaumer. Stahlbaumer at the 25-yard line. 20, 15, 10. Touchdown, Hanover. Have a flag down, though. A flag down inside of the 20-yard line.
They got a block in the back here on Fritzy. Fritzy blocked in the back.
Well,
right at the 20-yard line. It's a 20-yard line, so it's a huge turnover.
When you mentioned a little bit ago that their thing is offense, it is. But I almost think their thing is defense because Hanover is so good defensively. They only allow 5.5 points per game, and they completely shut down their last two opponents. It's a good argument to have, and right there, their defense coming up big.
Well, their offense, especially their defense, is their best offense. I would say that much. But they have an explosive offense, too. So,
yeah, you can't go wrong on either side of the football with them. But their defense strikes first here in this game, an interception of the quarterback from Dighton, Tyler Lane. So Hanover getting the football. They have it at the 28-yard line. 6:57 to go here, first quarter. It's going to be Carter Bruna. Bruna right up the middle, and he's going to be shoved back after picking up a couple of yards. Yeah, speaking of defense, Dighton had a pretty good defense, Coach.
Yeah, they do. They showed it right there, too. Carter Bruna would have kept his feet moving. He would just plow those guys over. He allowed them to stop his feet and shove him back. And, you know, one of those things where the whistle should have been blown a little bit earlier, but you know, the best thing about that defensive interception, I'm going to go back to that real quick, is that Hanover went to a man-to-man pass defense, and that was just helping them so much right there.
We are again on the play. It's going to be 2nd and 6 in the football. Yeah, another rough play here for Will Bruna. It was 2nd and 6. The football is the 23-yard line, and Bruna gets taken down for a short loss.
Yeah, the guy that took him down was the quarterback, you know, Ling, and he just took him down. Towering, taking down with 6'5", grabbing hold of him and hanging on.
Now, 3rd down coming up here. It's going to be 3rd down and 8. 3rd and 8 at 25. Shotgun snap to Will Bruna. No one open. He wants to run with the football. Now someone is open. It's Dietrich wide open. Forget about it. Touchdown. Touchdown, Hanover. It's a 25-yard touchdown pass play on 3rd and 8.
That is so... You know, temperamental about, I mean, not temperamental, but so the problem is with Will Bruna, he's a dual-purpose quarterback, and he's so hard to read. And he's kind of like the Auburn quarterback back in Cam Newton days where he would pull up and jump and throw a pass. That was such a great pass, a great read on his part.
Because no one was open initially, and he started probing like he was going to run. They thought, uh-oh, and so they started coming up, and Dietrich snuck up the left sideline. Nobody around him. Easy pass play for the score, and Hanover has tied up this football game at the 5:44 mark here of the first quarter.
It's a great play on Dietrich's part to keep yourself motion and keeping yourself moving.
And over here trying to take the lead for the first time. I formation behind quarterback Will Bruin. Here's a snap. Fake on the toss, and it looks like there was some movement on the Wildcat. It is. Procedure against Hanover, their second procedure penalty.
Which actually is good for them because it gives us more room to maneuver. You know, just like right there, they were back in the 28, maneuverability with Will Bruna, able to run, gamble, scramble, and basically get to the opening and find a guy.
Starting to warm up a little bit, Coach.
It's our private suite up here.
So Hanover backed up now. And they will try this two-point conversion again. Bruno looking right, throws it. It's going to be caught, and the catch is made. It's made by Zarbaniski. So Zarbaniski is going to be tackled just short of getting into the end zone. A couple of stoppers, Blair Hoffman and Lake Lewis, yeah, there for Dighton.
Lake Lewis is the one that knocked him out of bounds right before the goal line. I'd say Zarbaniski was dragging that guy into the goal line, and then Lake Lewis came in and laid the lumber on him and just knocked him out of bounds. Created the no scoring on the extra point.
The interception, though, setting up the good field position, and Dietrich scores on a pass play from 25 yards out. We're tied at 6 with 5:44 to go here in the first quarter. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
One field at a time. It's the promise that started it all back in 1946 and is still true today for Lewis Hybrids. From innovative products to their field-by-field placement decisions and replant program, you get more than just seed. You get personalized service that can help you reach your profit potential. Lewis Hybrids and Shaley Seed consider it a privilege to be your partner for success. One field at a time. Visit lewishybrids.com or contact your local Lewis dealer, Roger Shaley of Hanover, by calling 713-2336. Jones Trash Service provides residential and commercial waste pickup in Washington County. Their service is affordable, dependable, and professional. Jones Trash Service also offers roll-off containers to support your special projects. Whether it's renovation, cleanup, roof replacement, or yard clearing, they'll deliver the containers to you when you need it and remove it when your job is complete. Contact them for quotes for home or business trash service if you're not already on their route. Jones Trash Service of Washington.
And Hanover has tied the game at 6 apiece. The drive for them, 3 plays, 28 yards, and a time of 1:03. And Dighton, a touchback on that kickoff. They get the football once again at their 15-yard line for the second straight drive. Inside handoff, it's going to be Lake Lewis and Hanover. Oh, a fumble on the play. Fumble, and Hanover has it. Are they going to rule he was down? No, he was not down. And coming up with that fumble recovery was Zarbaniski.
Well, the guy that made knock the ball loose is Carlos Emmanuel, man. He just nailed that guy. He put a helmet right on the ball and just knocked it loose. And what great field position for Hanover right now.
Coach, what is going on with Dighton? Two consecutive turnovers on back-to-back offensive plays for them. If you're Hanover, you're saying, who cares? But, wow.
Hanover can be so opportunistic in this situation right here and kind of put things in their ball game and their tempo.
So the football at the 16-yard line. Bruna turns right, has to go back to his left on what appears to be a busted play and gets tackled for a loss of yards.
Yeah, that was that turnaround fake handoff that they do to confuse the defense and freeze the linebackers. And when he turned around twice, he kind of looked like a top there in the backfield, turned around twice and headed back to the left and gained some yardage out of it, but not too much.
Dahlbomber on that last drive with the interception that set up the football at the Dighton 28, and then Dietrich, a 25-yard touchdown reception on 3rd and 8 to give Hanover their only points. Right now it's 2nd and 11, football at the 17-yard line, 5-minute mark here the first quarter. Bruner rolling to his right, looking downfield, no one's open. Spins off one man, actually can't get away from him. Tyler Ling bring him down for the quarterback sack, so Hanover going backwards right now.
But Tyler Ling showing some defensive skills and some offensive skills in this game so far. I mean, being the quarterback and everything, but he just really is a great defensive end, which could be something he can look at for the next level also, because he definitely got the frame for it.
So now it's 3rd down and 12 at the 18-yard line. 3rd and 12 at the 18-yard line of Dighton. 4.5 to play here, opening quarter, state championship game. We're tied at 6. Hanover and Dighton. Hanover football. They have a bunch in a triangle on the right-hand side of the formation. Bruna pumps right, throws it left, sets up the screen to Stahlbomber. Stahlbomber trying to get a block at the edge, can't. And it's not even going to be close to a first down, so 4th down coming up.
Yeah, Dalton Hoffman was right there, and he just broke up that block with the receiver and just broke up the play, too. He just busted the play up. So it's a really good defensive move by Darren Hoffman of Dighton.
It was a 5-yard pass play there to Stahlbomber. So it's going to be 4th and 7 at the 13-yard line, a timeout for Hanover.
and probably not a bad one. No, they're fourth down. You know, this is, we've seen them score. You know, we watched them three times now, Trenton. Fourth down and 15, fourth down and what was it, 22 last game. They scored a touchdown. They're not scared. They're very confident in this area and very confident in their play calling of what they can do and what they can't do.
Yeah, I'm thinking back to last week. It was when the game was out of hand, but they did have a fourth down, a fourth and six at the Pike Valley 18-yard line in which Stahlbaumer connected with his cousin, Cade Kohorst, on an 18-yard touchdown pass play. But this is a big moment in the game because Dighton, when they're not turning over the football, they're moving it pretty good. So,
yeah.
Hanover a chance to take the lead in this one.
It's a good time to take the mojo away from them, that's for sure.
You have to make them pay for their mistake of turning over the football. Dighton has turned over the football in their last two offensive plays.
Like I said, Hanover can be very opportunistic in this situation. They need to keep that in mind. And I'm sure Dighton's thinking of what they're going to do and how they're going to do it.
What do you like here, 4th and 7, 13-yard line?
Oh, I like the Stahlbaumer down the middle or down across the side. He's got a good angle on the touchdown right now.
Run
him on a post pattern.
He's over on the right-hand side of the formation. Here's a throw, and it's going to be tipped and caught. Was he in?
Yes, he was.
He comes down with it. Adam Fritchie comes down with the football in the back of the end zone, just enough room for him to score.
Yeah, he just tiptoed it, his zigzag, and put it right into the end zone at the back of it. You know, I mean, the referee was right there, looked down, saw his feet in, and that was a great catch and a great throw because two Dighton defenders tipped that football.
Yeah, that's the thing about it. It was tipped, but not tipped enough to throw it off course to Adam Fritchie.
Well, it was great concentration on his part to wait for the ball, and then catch him, just snag it out of the air and just get his feet down.
Two-point conversion try here for Hanover. Carter Bruna motioning across the formation. Will, on play action, throws the football, and it's going to be caught for the two-point conversion. Adam Zarbaninski with the catch. He was wide, wide open on the near left side of the end zone. 14-6. Hanover takes the lead with 3:47 to go in the first quarter. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
Innovation. It doesn't always come easy, but it's always worth the struggle. We at Blue Valley Telecommunications understand how important innovation is to technology. As we look back on the past 60 years, we see how we've transformed telephone service through cables strung on fence posts to telephone, TV, and even high-speed internet over state-of-the-art fiber optic cables. As your technology provider, we're proud to have served you for the past 60 years and look forward to continuing to do that for years to come.
For any concrete project you need for a residential driveway, basement, patio, or curb, you can count on Midwest Products to handle it. At every level of the job, you'll find a dedicated, skilled crew prepared to deliver a professional job. With state-approved plants in Hanover, Clay Center, Lynn, and Washington, they can meet the needs of residential, commercial, or farm-related projects. For other ready-mix concrete work, give Midwest Products a call at 800-371-2252.
14 unanswered by Hanover and another kickoff. That's a touchback for the Wildcats. And so Dighton will have the football once again at their own 15-yard line. That drive for Hanover after the fumble by Dighton. Again, Dighton back-to-back turnovers on offensive plays. Four plays, 16 yards in the time of 1:49. Fritchie on 4th and 7 from the 13-yard line on the 13-yard touchdown reception from quarterback Will Bruna.
You know, the interesting thing about the kickoff was the first kickoff was done by Pete Peters. The last two kickoffs have gone out of the end zone at the Carter Bruna. So they switched their kickers and been pretty effective.
Out of the I formation now, Dighton with the football double tight. Play fake, Ling to throw the football. He is sacked, brought down, and
Stoves.
Yep, Jesse Stoves was the guy that got him.
Now that time, the defensive pocket of Hanover stayed really tight. Emmanuel was right there. He stayed really tight with his blocker and just allowed Stoves in his, collapsed that whole pocket right on Ling. It was a really, really good defensive stand that time. And a loss of, what, 5 yards.
Second down and 15 at the 10-yard line. They are doing a good job of putting up the down and distance immediately on the scoreboard because it is very confusing at times here looking at this field. Basically, I have two sets of markings on it. Here's a throw. It's going to be Ling connecting with Booz, but not for much. Not for much at all. Picked up a couple on that, so it's going to be third and very long, just a gain of 2 yards.
Yeah, like you said earlier, I mean, this defense for Hanover just closes so fast. They were playing the zone defense with the defensive backs at the beginning of the game. Now they switched to a man-to-man, which is really beneficial for Hanover because they have so much speed in the backfield of their defense with Dietrich and Stahlbaumer and Zarbatrisky, and they just played really well back there. Of course, then you got the monster back running around the side with Zarbatrisky.
Third down and 13 at the 12-yard line here for Dighton. And Dighton may be taking the time out here just to talk about things, and they are. They are coached by Ken Simon. He wants to talk with his kids. And Coach, you probably realize this is a pretty big moment in this game right now because his team is, they started so good. And they started so good that I was getting a little bit nervous. I was like, "They, you couldn't have asked for a better start if you were Dyke."
Exactly.
They go to march right down the field and score, and they look really good doing it.
Yeah, they had a good kickoff return, which put them up to a really good field position, and then they marched it right in from them. But since then, you know, the mojo, so to speak, has just switched over to Hanover, which is not surprising because Hanover just kind of steady Eddie in this situation because they have been here three straight times, and they know what they're doing. And they've been behind. You know, when we saw them play Boyd St. John's and Chesapeake, they were behind by a touchdown. They come back and they blow them out. They're used to playing from behind or ahead or whatever. They're just steady, confident, and their confidence is there for them to play a good ball game. And this right time, you're right. Timeout right now is big for Dighton and to make a play change and make a play decision on the next two plays because I don't think I see them punting unless they get held here deep in their territory.
So for Dighton right now, it is third and 13 at their own 12-yard line. It is Hanover up 14-6, 14 unanswered for the Wildcats. Ling holding onto the football, wanted to throw. Now it's going to take off and run with a Fritchie, forces him out of bounds. He should have the first down. It's going to be really close. Looks like he's No. When they remark it, he doesn't. He's going to be a yard short.
Now, he was doing the old professional or college football player. He just stretched the ball out, and they go by contact in high school. So he touched the out-of-bounds line with about 2 yards short of the first down.
So it's going to be fourth and one at the 24-yard line here for Dighton, and I think it's a no-brainer for them. They're going to go for it, especially when you have a quarterback that's 6'5". And if you're him, I mean, this is the state championship. You got to lay it all out with that frame. He's just got to dive ahead and make sure he has the first down.
Yeah, Hanover's going to fill the gaps right here because he's going to dive ahead.
High formation, double tights here for Dighton, ball on the air hash, fourth and one at the 24-yard line, and now he's going to take a timeout. A little bit surprised by that.
Well,
I know they were trying to draw him on. I get it, but that's just burning their second timeout. I thought they would just go for it.
Well, with 6'5", you think they would have, but you notice Hanover was scooting up into the gaps, and they were going to fill the gaps and shoot the gaps, so... I don't know, 6'5", I think you would have made the first down pretty easily, but that's a confidence thing right there, too, once again.
Now, the one thing they haven't done well is run the football. That's the one thing that's been going in favor of Hanover is when Dighton runs, it's been the advantage towards Hanover, but it is only a yard. But, as you said, maybe he didn't like what he saw right there. So it is 14-6 our score. Hanover leading in this football game, 2:18 to go in the first quarter. They have scored the last 14 points. It's all about turnovers. Turning over the football. Dighton's turned it over twice, and Hanover's turned it into 14 points.
Exactly. That's what, like you said earlier, Hanover's built that way. They're built with speed. They're built with defense. They've got the bodies to kind of go in and out. You'll see Emmanuel playing offense. You see him playing defense only, and he's loving it. He's more of a defensive specialist is what he is.
Defense is really what got Hanover going because Dighton scored. Hanover had a 3-and-out. And things didn't look that great early on, but then Hanover, on their second defensive series, forced that turnover that got things turned around. So Dighton is going for it. They spread it out a little bit with receivers on each side of the formation, and now Hoffman is emptying out. It is going to be the quarterback running the football, easily getting the first down as he takes it to the 28-yard line. So he picks it up easily.
Yes.
It's 4 yards on that run.
That was just a good call. He went up through the A gap between the guard and the center right there and just put the ball – his hands around the ball and just used his body, used his frame, and pick up the first down.
Dighton now 2-for-2 on fourth downs in this game. Their other one was on Ling's 4-yard touchdown run to give them their only point. 1st and 10 now for Dighton at the 28-yard line, just inside of 2 minutes to go here in quarter one. 14-6 to score, Hanover on top. High formation behind quarterback Tyler Ling. He's going to toss it to Dylan Foos, who's in the backfield. Tries to cut it up, but cuts right into Adam Fritchie, and Fritchie tackles him. 3-yard loss.
And Dietrich came up from his cornerback spot there so quick and turned the corner. And like I said earlier, I noticed with Hanover, their cornerbacks, Dietrich and Stahlbaumer, are just like defensive ends. They just come in and close in and book in and did a really good job of keeping getting the outside.
Second down, 11 at the 27-yard line here for Dighton. Dighton, again, going left to right as we view it in black. Black and orange, their colors. Again, Oregon State-like colors. And they are going west to east here in this first half. 14-6, they trail. Another timeout.
That's their third one for the half. They're done.
Wow, they've used all three timeouts on this drive. All three.
In the first quarter, even. Ken Simon must be seeing something that we're not seeing in Hanover's weakness of defense, that's for sure.
Well, and as I said, Coach, he could probably feel that this is a pretty important drive for his football team right now. Because, again, things look really great for him early on. They score on their first series, force Hanover to a three and out. But then things flip as Dighton turns it over with an interception. Stahlbaumer had a pickoff, and then it was Zarbin Niski with a fumble recovery on back-to-back possessions, back-to-back play for Dighton. And Hanover was able to cash in. Dietrich, a 25-yard touchdown reception, and Fritchie, a 13-yard touchdown reception on back-to-back series for Hanover from quarterback Will Bruna. Bruna, I have him a perfect 4-of-4 throwing the football unofficially for 51 yards and two touchdown passes. So things have just flat flipped here in this state championship game.
Yeah, I mean, you're looking at the thing is that basically it's the two players that Dighton has really that make a lot of contribution right now are Link and Foose and in their pass plays. So because Lewis hasn't got his running game going and neither is Hoffman.
Second down, 11 at the 27-yard line here for Dighton. Ling out of the shotgun with a back to his left, wins over to the far side, left ball between the hashes. Ling in the pocket, throws a deep ball down the far sideline. He overshoots the intended target. That was Foose. He was being defended by Dietrich. Stahlbaumer came over to help.
And Stahlbaumer was over the top that time. He had a man-to-man with a zone coverage that time, a cover two more or less on that, because they had a man-to-man with a guy over the top, and that was Stahlbaumer over the top. Chase went long.
I have Ling now throwing the football 4-of-7 unofficially, 28 yards and an interception. By the way, that interception, just his fifth of the season. Ling, 43 touchdowns, 4 interceptions coming into today's championship. Those are big-time numbers.
Yeah, I'm just worried right now. Hanover's going to cover that middle because at the time Ling had a wide-open running space in the middle also.
Third and 11 at the 27-yard line here for Tyler Ling. Ling rolling to his right, makes a throw. The pass could be caught by Foose. What a catch. Caught that on Dietrich, and Dietrich has played him well.
Dietrich was like white on rice on that one, man. He was all over him, and it was just crazy because he kind of, I hadn't really caught that because Dietrich even hit the ball before it went into his hands. That was just great pass defense on Dietrich's part, and somehow Foose still caught the ball and brought it in. Great hands, great pass. You could tell they worked in the backyard together out there in Kansas a few times.
So now it's first and 10 at the 35-yard line of Hanover. An 18-yard pass play there for the Hornets. Here's a pitch to the far side. This is Blake Lewis. Puts the move on the defender, gets past Dietrich, but then Dietrich gets some help out from Adam Fritchie. Fritchie brings him down and all that for just a gain of one.
Yeah, they really spread him out that time, like I said before. You know, these quarterbacks that Hanover has of Fritchie and Dietrich, they just really play the field, and they really cover a lot of field because of their speed.
So now it's second down. Second down and nine, and a long nine. Second down and nine at the 34-yard line. Snap back to Ling out of the shotgun. Pumps, now throws, and he completes the pass. It will be caught just short of the first down. And making that catch, David Kramer. The tackle made by Zavatrisky. Zavatrisky with that tackle, and that was the final play of the first quarter. It is 14-6. Hanover up on Dighton. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY.
One thing's for sure, Marysville Livestock is proud to serve the area farmers and ranchers and always welcome you to their weekly sales. They're held every Thursday at 11 a.m. Well, there's lots of cattle to choose from in one location. Different sizes, weights, breeds, genders, horns, age, and a lot more. Give Marysville Livestock a call when you have cattle ready for sale or to go to market. To consign your cattle, call 562-1015. The number again, 562-1015. Marysville Livestock hopes to see you round the barn on sale day.
Are you tired of wondering where your certified wheat came from? Or are you tired of overpaying for new seed wheat? Oldie Seed is offering their direct buying program on new certified wheat seed. With a downturn in the wheat prices, Oldie Seed understands the struggles growers go through when making new purchase decisions. Call Oldie Seed today to book your direct seed purchases at $8.70 per unit and premium full seed treatment for $4.50. Call Oldie Seed today, where they have your back.
Third down and one at the 26-yard line of Hanover for Dighton right now. Hanover up 14-6 to be the first play of the second quarter. Lake Lewis getting the call, and Lewis should have the first down. Gets it easily as he takes it inside of the right at the 20. We'll see exactly where the spot, right at the 25 or just slightly inside of it, just slightly inside of the 25-yard line.
Yeah, that's a good off-tackle, I mean off-guard play at a time run by Dighton. Real safe play. Just enough to get the first down. It gets four more downs so they can kind of control the clock. The advantage right here is Hanover keeping Dighton on the field because they only have, like I said, the strength of eight players who can wear them out physically.
10th play of the drive coming up here for Dighton. Handoff left side, and boy, the back bounces off of a man. That was Dalton Hoffman, and Hoffman, I thought he was just going to get leveled in the backfield, but he's slippery. The 5'8 sophomore was able to slip off that tackle and get up the field for a couple of yards.
Yeah, Zabotrisky was right there and just didn't wrap him up good enough. He hit him really hard, but just didn't wrap him up.
Goes down to the gain of 3 yards for Dalton Hoffman. That's his first carry of the game. So now it's 2nd and 7 at the 22-yard line here for Dighton. Dighton now going right to left, east to west here in this second quarter. Twins to the near left wide side of the field for quarterback Tyler Lane. Lewis to his left, and it's going to be a lead play for the quarterback. But Hanover, they're right there. Stopping it is Hanover's Carlos Emmanuel with the tackle. No gain.
Yeah, he read that out, sifted out really well, and it was just right there. And he wrapped him up really well. That's all Hanover's going to do is wrap these guys up and take him to the ground because if they don't, they're pretty quick and they can agility. Their agility is really good where they can bounce off.
3rd and 7 at the 22-yard line here for Dighton at the Hanover 22-yard line. Hanover leading 14-6 with 10:25 to go here in the first half. Out of the pistol formation, here's a snap. Ling rolling to his right, looking downfield, makes the throw, and it's going to be caught. Wow, over the top of two defenders. That ball perfectly placed to David Kramer. I thought for a minute that
Ball Palmer's going to get it.
Hell, and yet Zabotrisky there, too. I thought for a minute it was going to be Zabotrisky who was going to make the pick, but it didn't happen.
Well, Hanover almost like stopped right there and watched the ball too much. They should have went up and just batted the ball down. They were just to watching the. Oh, they thought, oh, he's out of bounds. Once again, they could have got switched up with the lines like we are.
Yeah, again, it is very confusing. This is a football field, also a soccer field, so you have football numbers out there for a regular size 100-yard field, but they're not accurate for 8-man. So they have the 8-man yardage on the sidelines here, so it gets very confusing. Lines all over the place. Markings all over the place. Ling throwing it to Boone. Boone comes down with it, and this game, just like that, is tied. That was a two-point conversion. 14-14, 10-13 to go in the first half. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
Things are always changing. It's certainly true of the world around us, but it's also true of Ray's Apple Market. They keep up with what's trending in foods as people discover new recipes, try new products, and some require special diets. Ray's Apple Market works hard to stock their shelves with a variety of grocery items you need and want. The bottom line is, it's all about the customer satisfaction. For your ever-changing family needs, shop your locally owned, community-minded Ray's Apple Market.
I was going over invoices when in walked Al. Can I help you, Mr. Gore?
Well, Central Office Service and Supply Guy, I'm always trying to do my part for the environment. I'm restocking my office supplies and wondered if you could help me with the cause.
How about this AA multi-purpose 96 bright white 20-pound paper? It's made from farmed trees, so it's sustainable and environmentally friendly. It works in all machines and is just $41.95 for one case or $39.95 for five or more.
Perfect! I can feel my carbon footprint shrinking as we speak. Now, if you'll excuse me, my private jet is waiting.
Hey, welcome back to the game now. Tied at 14 apiece, 10-13 to go here in this first half. Logan Ling getting set to kick off for the Dighton Hornets. Back deep for Hanover. Thomas Atkins, here is the kickoff, and this one Atkins won't be able to handle this out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The drive for Dighton impressive. 11 plays, 65 yards, and a time of 6 minutes even. It was Kramer on the 22-yard touchdown reception. Foos added the 2-point conversion catch. So again, we're tied up at 14 apiece. And again, Dighton's really good when they don't turn over the football offensively. Two touchdown drives, but two possessions in which they turned it over. So Hanover gets the football at their own 15-yard line here in a tie game with 10-13 to go in the first half. In the first ever meeting between these two schools, Hanover and White going left to right. Quick throw, screen set up for Stahlbaumer, and Stahlbaumer couldn't get the block he needed. He's brought down, looks like, for a short loss on the play. And a little slap pass out there, a little wide receiver screen to the left. Bruna took a step back, two steps, threw it, shot to Stahlbaumer. But Dighton just sniffed it out really well and defended it extremely well. They're probably used to defending that quarterback readily with their quarterback and their offense.
That was defensive end Isaac Torsten who made that tackle. He's 6'3", 170 pounds, a junior. Second and 10, 15-yard line here for Hanover. Snap to Bruna. Bruna looking left, looking middle. Now dumps it over the middle of the pass. Going to be incomplete. Good tackle there by Dylan Foos. Adam Zarbaniski was the intended target. He couldn't hold on to it because Foos was on him in a heartbeat. That's the first incompletion thrown by Will Bruna. But it was there. It's unfortunately a drop, and it's really a great defensive play when it comes down to it.
It was a drag route by the tight end. There's Zarbaniski, and he just dropped it. He had it in his hands, just dropped it. This is a big play here for Hanover.
It is third down and 10. Third down and 10 at the 15-yard line for Hanover. Bruno pumps, now throws it deep for Dietrich. He's open. He beats both defenders. Dietrich still on his feet. 30, 20, 15, and tackles now finally inside of the 5-yard line. Wow.
That was just a great play. I tell you, that's what I think they ought to be doing more of, because right now Hanover has the speed. What I've been noticing is Dighton's defense has been shooting up so much that the middle is wide open. There was a great play call by Matt Huer that time to get him open and stretch the field that time and use what he has, the speed of Hanover.
Pass play of 61 yards. Kevin Dietrich with that catch. First and goal at the 4-yard line here for Hanover. Out of the I formation, it's going to be Carter Bruna. Bruna gets swallowed up, but he does at least get positive to get the yard on the play.
That was a good call by Coach Hoyer, that he came back to that and did a good job with the fullback on that time to try to mix it up.
And again, the big catch came on a third and 10 play. Third and 10 play for Hanover. And now it's second and goal at the 3-yard line for the Wildcats. We're tied at 14 here in the state championship. 8:40 to go in the first half. Handoff, huge hole left side, and Carter Bruna goes in. Adam Fritchie, Trevor Clip, a great job. Left guard, center combination there. And scoring again was Carter Bruna.
That was just a read option right there. It was a great read by Will Bruna. Gave it to his brother Carter and just took a right there. Nobody stopped that freight train going through. That's just a great play.
So Hanover, a quick answer. They lead 20-14 here at the 8:38 mark of the first half. Single setback, Carter Bruna. Dietrich, the receiver on the right side, and it's a handoff to Carter Bruna. Slow developing play, and Bruna gets drugged down and stopped on the two-point conversion try. Lake Lewis, the tackle for Dighton. Hanover leads, though, 20-14, 8:38 to go in the first half. You're listening to Hanover Football on KCLY 100.9.
We all like shopping for gifts, but what we really like is getting everything on our list all in one place. Patterson Health Mart Pharmacy and Radio Shack is your one-stop gift headquarters. You can print off your digital photos to include in your Christmas cards or make photo gifts for faraway friends and relatives. There's an assortment of candles, toys, electronics, jewelry, and homemade fudge. Fudge? Oh yeah, that's for me. Don't forget the batteries at Patterson Health Mart Pharmacy and Radio Shack in Clay Center.
You must prepare for tomorrow and make ready the fields for next spring. At Wilbur Ellis Read, Seed, and Feed, we're not psychic, we don't read palms or cast spells, but we do read fields, see what works, and offer you the products we know will help with your profit potential. We start with cleaning up the weeds, adding residual for control into the spring, and apply fall fertilizer with or without stabilizers for a head start to next year's crop. No magic, just simple, straightforward solutions. We are Wilbur Ellis, Reed, Seed, and Feed.
And here's a kickoff from Carter Bruna. It's going to be taken in by Dylan Foos. Foos at the 15, angling here to the near side of the 20-yard line. Trying to get around a pack of Hanover Wildcats, finally going out of bounds at the 25-yard line. That drive for Hanover as they reclaim the lead. They lead 20-14. Four plays, 65 yards in the time of 1:35. It was Carter Bruna
a 3-yard touchdown run. But the big play of the drive came on 3rd and 10 at their own 15-yard line. Will Bruna connecting with Kevin Dietrich on a 61-yard pass play. So Dighton back with the football here. They have it at the 25. They actually marked him out at the 23-yard line. 8:31 to go here in the half. It is Hanover up 20-14.
And Foose is a very elusive running back.
He's good. He's receiver slash running back. He does it all for him. He could even play quarterback. And he is the backup quarterback, by the way, and no shocker there. And no shocker here is Tyler Lynn carries the football for pretty good yardage. Picks up 5 on that carry off the right side as he takes it to the 27.
And that's kind of been open all night. So I talked to you earlier is that even on the pass plays, when the pocket starts to collapse, the middle opens wide open, he should be probably using that more to his ability because he is a good running quarterback also.
They don't run him a lot. It's 226 yards rushing coming into this game. They didn't need to. 2nd and 5 of the 27-yard line here for Dighton. They trail by 6. Here's a snap. Shotgun snap to Ling. Ling moves to his right, makes the throw downfield. Pass to be caught. And making that catch for them, that was the sophomore, Dalton Hoffman.
And yeah, that was a nice play because what they did was they drug out the Hanover D-backs, took them deep, and they just opened up a hole there at the mid-range level in the defense and just created basically a hole in the defense where they make the pass play.
Hoffman's 17th catch of the year. That one goes for 15 yards, so it's 1st and 10 at the Hanover 38-yard line. 7:47 to go here before halftime. 20-6, Hanover leads out of the pistol. And it's going to be Lane keeping the football off the right side on the read. And he will take it to the 34-yard line, gain of 4.
That's kind of a read option again by his part because it's kind of basically a half-triple option, basically what it was, two-thirds in the way. He just faked it to the fullback, and everybody bit on the fullback. He just pulled it from the fullback's belly and went around up 5 yards on the end.
2nd down and 6 to the Hanover 34-yard line. Again, the Wildcats up by 6 points. Out of the pistol here. 2 receivers here to the left side of the formation. It's going to be a handoff right side. Lake Lewis able only to manage 1 there on that carry. Several stoppers in there, including Adam Fritchie. Just a gain of 1 for Lake Lewis. They really never have got Lake Lewis going in this game. He came in as a top rusher for Dighton, 700 yards, averaging almost 8 yards per carry. Well, in this game, 4 carries for 3 yards. That's not getting it done, and credit Hanover. 3rd down and 5 at the 33-yard line here for Dighton. Hanover up by 6. 7-minute mark of the first half. Snap back to Tyler Ling. Ling looking left, nothing there. He's going to run it back to his right. He's going to run with the football. And Ling gets the first down as he was ushered out by Adam Fritchie on the Hanover sideline across the field.
Yeah, like I said, you know, Hanover's making some subs in there right now. They're kind of platooning a little bit with Adam. With Austin Ginkle in there playing defensive end, Stowes, and giving some Stowes some break on the offensive part too. But I guess Stowes is still there. He's subbed in for Clip, as we Trevor Clip, as we subbed in for.
He's smart too. He needed 5. He got 6, and it's 1st and 10 at the 27-yard line here for Dighton, driving down by 6. Out of the pistol, Ling with Lewis behind him. Fake to him, and then he fakes to Hoffman, and he flips it to Hoffman.
Oh,
he was being tackled. Hoffman makes the catch, gets past Dietrich. Stahlbomber finally brings him down. What a play that was.
Yeah, because Clip came back in the game. Clip makes a great pressure on him, got him by the ankles on the left side, on the right side, and then all of a sudden, Hoffman's leg just flips it. I mean, it wasn't even a pass. It was just like a forward lateral flipping through the air, and he caught the ball and went down the field about 15 yards. What an interesting play.
That goes as an 18-yard pass play. It's now 1st and goal at the 9-yard line.
I think they drew that one up in the dirt before they threw a couple on that time, Trent.
Huge play for them. 1st and goal at the 9. Ball in the near hash. Getting out of the pistol. And now getting the football. It's Dalton Hoffman, and Hoffman gets tackled for a short gain. May not have gained anything.
I don't think so. I think Clip was on that side. He did a really good job. Clip took on 2 blockers that time and then allowed the linebackers to get there with Dietrich and
what they do. And what they do on that play is they fake, they ran it several times. They fake the dive to Lewis, and then they have the end around with Hoffman. And they faked it to him several times. Finally, they gave it to him there, and Hanover would wait.
They have an option to pitch that way, too, also.
No gain on the play. Second down and goal at the 9-yard line. Ling, play action and out flag. Hasn't been very many against Dighton. They've played a clean game so far. Procedure against them. That's their first procedure call.
Now, I remember last time it happened to Hanover. He killed their drive. Well, we'll do the Dighton this time. But you're right, that play is an interesting play because they've got basically three options off it. They're on the same play every time. And basically, it's a quarterback read. He can either pull the ball out of the fullback, pitch it, or else he can hand off to the receiver coming around on reverse.
So now it's second down and goal at the 14-yard line. That's just Dighton's second penalty. The only other one was when they kicked off the football out of bounds after they scored their first touchdown. Second and goal at the 14-yard line. Here's a snap. Fake to Lake Lewis. Ling running off the right side. Hanover right there. Carlos Emmanuel in on that tackle. Also, Brian Lupin with the tackle for the Wildcats as well.
And Fritchie had him down low, too, and really tripped him up down there, too. So it's just a really good team defense that time, how they swarmed the ball. Hanover was swarming really well. They didn't know there was a sub here. Carter Bruner's in the game now. A linebacker trying to get some breaks to some people, too, and put a little more meat in there.
That goes down to the loss of one. So we have third down and goal at the 15-yard line here for Dighton. Quarterback hit as he throws the football. It is caught, though. It is caught by Dylan Smooth. Not a huge game. He gets brought down right at the 10-yard line. Just pass play of 5 yards. So a fourth down coming up. It will be fourth down and goal at the 10-yard line.
Yeah, it's been an interesting drive, especially here towards the end, because the fourth down marker, the downs marker guy, has been the one walking up at end.
And I have
sideline.
Dighton 2-for-2 on fourth downs. Fourth and goal at the 10-yard line, and over up 20-14, 4:42 to go here in the first half. Dighton has no timeouts. Ling taking his time. This could be a direct snap here. It's snapped to Hoffman. Hoffman then gives it to Booth, and Booth throws it into the end zone, and it's intercepted by Stahlbaumer. A trick play that didn't trick anyone. The pass was intended for Kramer. Stahlbaumer coming up with what is his second interception.
That was quite a trick play, too, Trent. Well, that was Ling starts to go into shotgun. He steps back, and he steps up like he's calling out professional plays, of calling out the blocks for the lineman. And then what happens, they snap it to their deep back, which was Hoffman. Okay, Hoffman throws it down the middle of the field, looking for Ling, their big 6'5 quarterback, in the middle of the end zone.
Three turnovers for Dighton in the first half. So the football is at the 1-yard line. Stahlbaumer tried to bring it out.
And I thought he would have down at the end zone, and it had on the 15-yard line. Now they got an offside on Hanover, and it's going to be half a distance to the end zone, which is basically the 6-inch line.
So,
half of a foot is 6 inches, I think, still. So all I know is that they're going to move the tip of the football right back to...
I'm with you. I thought Stahlbaumer went down when he made that kick, but no, he tried to run it out. He got brought down to the 1, so it is 1st and 10 now. The football just inside of the 1-yard line for Hanover, but they're glad they get it.
Yeah.
Up 20-14 with 4:35 to go in the half. See if they can put together a 79-yard drive here. Bruna in trouble, makes the throw, and he just has to throw it away as he was in the grass.
That was a smart play. That shows you the senior leadership of Will Bruna. He saw the guy coming. He was waiting for his guy to break open. And the guy just didn't get broken, but instead he throws it down the field past everybody. So it shows the athleticism and the arm he has.
So again, coming up with that interception for Hanover, Dakin Stahlbaumer, the sophomore, with 2 here in the state championship game. What a first half for him.
Yeah, just tell you something interesting here. Is interesting watching the umpire put the ball down, because it's so close to the goal line, it's almost like he has to put a laser down before he puts it down.
Second down and 10 at the 1-yard line here for Hanover. Bruna to throw the football. Throws it down the middle for Fritchie, and it's intercepted. It is picked off by Blair Hoffman. And Hoffman makes the interception, and that's the first turnover for Hanover. So Hanover gives back the football. Dighton, they'll take possession down 20-14 with 4:23 to play here in the first half.
Yeah, that's kind of a frustrating series there for Will Bruna. He started off with a penalty, and... it almost kind of took his head out of the game in some ways, but they really recovered well. And then once again, we're coming back to what you talked about earlier in the game, Trent, was Hanover's defense and how effective they are. And if they hold them here, they'll be even more effective.
Blair Hoffman with the interception, so Dighton takes control at the 20-yard line of Hanover. 4:21 to go, and here's a throw, and it's going to be tipped. Stahlhammer got a hand on it. Good coverage. It's a deep shot into the end zone, and the intended target, that was Food, down that far sideline.
I tell you what, Hanover does a lot of good job of subbing, because of, like, right now they got Thomas Atkins in there playing quarterback on the other side here, opposite of the opposite of Stahlhammer and Dietrich.
I have Ling unofficially 10 of 14 for 113 yards throwing the football, but for two interceptions.
Oh, I see what they did. They moved Fritzy up to defensive end to give us quickness there. That's a good idea. Really good idea there, by Coach.
Second down and 10 at the 20-yard line. A handover here for Dighton. They trail over 20 to 14, and Lane fakes on the handoff, keeps himself off that left side, and takes it down close to the 15-yard line.
They had me fooled on that one. I thought he had him stuck in the backfield. Black trees are hard to read the ball exchange sometimes.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings up a third and five at the 15-yard line. At the Hanover 15-yard line for Dighton. And Hanover leading 20 to 14. 3:49 to go in the half. Dighton breaks the huddle. Who's over on the right side of that formation? Twins right. Also out that right side is Dalton Hoffman. Out of the pistol. Ling rolling the pocket right. Making the throw. It's intercepted by Kevin Dietrich. Wow, a lot of turnovers in this first half. The pass was intended for Dalton Hoffman, but it's interception number 3 for quarterback Tyler Lang.
Yeah, that time it was really interesting what Hanover did. They had a 3-man rush set up, and then as the pass, as it was centered, they pulled Fritzy back into the flat, which put him in front of the pass receiver and allowed Dietrich to come in from behind and snag the ball. That was just a really good defensive switch, really good movement on the defense that time by Hanover.
Hanover hits the football at their own 11-yard line with 3:32 to go before halftime. But with 4 turnovers against Dighton, Hanover has to make them pay. I mean, they have to take a bigger lead than 6 points in the locker room. I think they really need a score here. Motion across the formation. Here's a snap to Will Bruna. Bruna sets up in the pocket, throws it deep. He has a man down the right side. It's caught by Thomas Atkins. Atkins now moving to his left. Dylan Food finally tracks him down. But what a catch there. What a throw.
Well, not only is the catch, but the run afterwards. Atkins could have went down the right sideline. Instead, he decides to take the angle, which gives him more yardage. He takes it on down at the angle right there and allows Foose to come in. Luckily, I thought he was going to get the ball knocked loose, but he had the ball tucked away really well at the time. And Atkins did a great job. Plus, on top of that, Atkins' frame was used that time. Atkins has a frame of a 6'2" guy, and he used all of it that time to go up and get that ball over the top of the Dighton defender.
That was a 46-yard pass play. So it's first and 10 at the 23-yard line of Dighton here for Hanover. Bruna throws it to Dietrich. Dietrich can't hold on to it, and he takes a big shot at the end of that from Blair Hoffman, and it's just a legal hit, and it's going to be second down.
Well, Hoffman was just letting him know that I'm here still. I'm here, and I'm defending you. It's a little bit of a love tap, so to speak, but it's pretty much a hard love tap. That's tough love right there.
Atkins with the 46-yard catch that sets this up. At second down now and 23 after that miss right there on that pass play. Second and 10 at the 23-yard line at Dighton, 20 to 14. Hanover with the advantage, exactly 3 minutes to go in the half. Bruna moves to his left, throws over the middle. It's going to be caught. Zabatrisky with the catch, gets the first down and then some. Still on his feet to take the whole nest of Hornets to bring him down. May have a flag down the field. I can't tell. Looks like maybe one down across the far side. Maybe it's just a leaf that's blown in. I'm not quite sure. I guess maybe a leaf.
Yeah. Maybe some of that yellow paint flaked off, too. I don't know. But I don't see any flag out there, Trent.
Okay.
That's good, then. So it's first and goal for Hanover.
That's a 20-yard pass play.
Dighton's middle has been real susceptible to those kind of plays.
And Carter Bruna taking the football, and he takes it in right off that left side again behind Fritchie and Cliff. The left guard center combination, and he scores his second rushing touchdown.
Yeah, Fritchie's becoming the X factor a little bit here. He switched to defense. He was playing quarterback on defense, switched to defensive end on defense, caused the last turnover, I believe, with that for Hanover on that pass, because he moved back to defense. Now he's blocking. He's just kind of an X factor right now for Hanover.
Well, Hanover answered the call. Not only did they scored quickly, but they have it now for the two-point conversion try up 26-14. Single receiver to the right side, that's Dietrich. And Bruno, they hand it off to him, and this just does not work. They try to go to him twice on the two-point conversion. It doesn't work, but the good news is Hanover, they lead now 26-14 with 2:47 to go in the first half. You're listening to Hanover Wildcats State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
Even if the tailpipe on your combine is still warm, it's time to place next year's seed order. Central Valley Ag has a financing plan you need to look at.
0% seed financing until January 15th of 2018.
CVA Seed Director Chad Udbuddy is also offering price discounts, even if you make changes later.
We're giving a discount on the dollars that you are submitting an order for today.
It's easy to order from Central Valley Ag. Get details at cvacoop.com.
Services for 89-year-old Marion Albert will be held on Thursday. She died November 18th at the Leonardville Nursing Home in Leonardville, Kansas. Visitation will be held from 3 to 8 p.m. on Monday.
For over 65 years, Hanover Electric has served the area with all their electrical, plumbing, heating, and air conditioning needs. They appreciate the support they've received from the local area year after year and the friends they've made along the way. Hanover Electric is proud to welcome new clientele and look forward to many years of working together. They will continue to provide excellent service to the community. Hanover Electric keeps everything running efficiently.
And welcome back. Dylan Foods on the return for the Dighton Hornets. He takes the football out to the 22-yard line, so that's where they will start with it, with 2:42 to go before halftime. 26-14, Hanover with the advantage. After Kevin Dietrich's interception, they took possession at the 11-yard line. Scored quickly. Four plays, 69 yards, and 45 seconds. Carter Bruno with a 3-yard touchdown run. The big play was Atkins, a 46-yard reception on that series. First and 10 here again. Dighton at their own 22-yard line. Play fake. Ling to throw the football. Hit as he throws. The pass will be incomplete. Lake Lewis had it, but he couldn't quite reel it in. He was sandwiched between a couple of defenders. One of them was Zarbaneski.
And the other one, Carter Bruno. And that's a pretty big piece of bread on both sides of the sandwich.
No kidding. That's 410 pounds of young men there.
I would not want to be between those two slices of bread, let me tell you about it now.
2:37 to go here in the half. Second and 10 for Dighton. 26-14. Hanover on top. Twins to each side of the formation. Three-man front here for Hanover. Quick throw, Lewis, not expected in, juggling. He didn't turn quite in time, and that's why he wasn't prepared for it. He was juggling it, never could hold on to it. Incomplete, and then a hold, coach, against Dighton on top of that.
Yeah, that's a huge play right there. I tell you what, he was juggling so much, I thought Spotbomber was going to come up there and just snatch it out of the air and take it in for a touchdown. That was just a great play. And then Spotbomber sit there waiting on him. He just went finally out of the bounds, but then you got a holding call here. This is a huge penalty right now for Dighton and a huge emotion taker.
It's just their third penalty of this game so far. And again, they have no timeouts left. They burned them all in one series. So no timeouts. They're down 26-14. 2:32 to go here before halftime. The Wildcats of Hanover on top.
And they're kind of playing in the Hanover's Oh, here we go. We got the referees getting frustrated with the lines here, too, now. A little bit. They got confused.
It is confusing. Hanover trying to win their first state championship again since 2009. They've made it three consecutive years, but lost the last 2 years. Second and 10 here from, I should say, longer than that. Here's a throw, Lake Lewis. Lake Lewis catches the football. It goes down to the 15-yard line. Pass play of 6 yards. That's going off the scoreboard, and for once, they're off.
As it's a middle screen pass right there, he pulled him back there, Ling did, and then passed it down there to Lewis, and they had a little screen pass, middle screen pass set up there, and they did a really good job. But once again, Hanover did a really good job of closing in and making it a small gain.
Third down and 18, football at the 15-yard line. Trips to the right-hand side of the formation, single receiver to the left side here for Dyke.
Ball between the hashes. Ling takes a snap. He flushes right. Fritchie catches him from behind and drops him for the quarterback sack.
Once again, I tell you, the last 3-5 minutes here in this game, Fritchie has been the X factor. He's been great on defense. They moved you to defensive end. He gets some more speed on the defensive end. He just came in from behind him, and Ling had no clue. He was basically blindsided. His left guard did not help him at all. But
Hanover smartly uses the timeout here because you have 1:33 to go before halftime. They're going to have to punt. They can't go for it in this situation. You can't. I guess you could, but it wouldn't be smart.
Well, the other thing is,
and Hanover has two timeouts.
They have two timeouts. They also could get the ball before the half. They also could score a touchdown, and they are receiving the kickoff opening up the second half because Dighton opened the game up with the reception of the kickoff there. So they could possibly get two scores here on them right here before the half is one and another one after the half, and they're going for the throat, and that's definitely the way to go.
So it's a 4th and 22 play. Big-time quarterback sack there. 4 yards lost on that sack. Adam Fritchie with the sack there. And, again, he's had a huge first half. There's been a lot of guys having a huge first half for Hanover. It's 4th and 22. The football is at the 11-yard line. And 1:43. It looks like they put some time back on the clock. 1:43 to go before halftime. Two timeouts for Hanover. Dighton scored the first points of the game, but they've had trouble turning over the football. They have 4 turnovers in this game.
Now, they could do something here. They've been passed the whole time. What the Hanover has to be aware of is a draw play. But now they look like they're going to punt it.
Yeah, I just couldn't see him chancing it. Back to take this punt, it is Thomas Atkins. He's the guy that had the big catch on the last touchdown drive for Hanover. Ling standing in his own end zone. Here's a snap, a wobbly one. Barely gets off that kick. It's a good one, though. Atkins takes it for a fair catch, and he makes the fair catch inside of his own 35.
And Hanover is lucky because they came in pretty close and almost rolled that punter. So that was a close call right there. So Hanover ball back with 1:37 to go before half. And so they really got a score on this one to kind of put it out of reach, so to speak.
Great chance to knock them out here with this drive and the opening drive that you brought up to start the second half. Hanover struck quickly on their last series. Just took 45 seconds to score on that last series. 1st and 10 at their own 32-yard line. Dietrich emptying out of the backfield, going to the left short side of the field. Bruno rolling right. Moves back to his left. Pumps down, throws over the middle. It's Darbinitsky makes the catch. He gets forced out of bounds. That'll stop the clock with 1:30 to go before halftime as he takes it just across midfield.
Darbinitsky did a good job of just dragging his man across the field. And, that, you know, they ran that play for their extra point. They ran that play a while ago, and he dropped the ball, so they went back to him. And that's just basically, you watch Will Bruno, he's just checking him down. He's going long, medium, short. Oh, there's my tight end. I'll pass the ball to him.
9-yard gain, and he's doing a great job of spreading the wealth in this game, passing to a lot of different guys. 2nd and 1 at the Dighton 39-yard line. Hanover up 26-14. Shotgun snap to Will Bruno. Bruno in some trouble. Completes the pass to Stahlbaumer out in the right flat, and Stahlbaumer has a first down inside of the 35. Dylan Booth and others blowing up there. Not a huge gain, but it is a first down gain of 5 yards.
That's a good gain. Now they got 4 fresh plays. They got 1:18 to go. They still got plenty of time to make a touchdown here before half. But the other smart thing is you got your quarterback, Will Bruna, and your backup quarterback, Stahlbaumer, finding each other. Stahlbaumer's been a really, really good relief valve for Will Bruna today.
He did a great job taking over the team at quarterback when Bruna went down last week against Pike Valley. 1st and 10 at the 34-yard line at Dighton here for Bruna and company. Here's a pass over the middle. Nice move as it is Darbinitsky who makes 2 people miss. He has blockers in front of him, still onto his feet, and he goes down inside of the 10, inside of the 10-yard line.
That was a great move. Tell you what, he came across at an angle that time. It's just a drag route, kind of post pattern. He makes the first guy miss, and then the second guy miss, and then also he picks up a block downfield from Dietrich and just picked up a lot of yards there.
27 yards on that pass play. So now it's 1st and goal at the 7-yard line. Here's a pump throw to Dietrich. Does he bring it down?
He does. Touchdown.
Kevin Dietrich, for the 2nd time in this football game, has a touchdown catch, this one of 7 yards.
That was a great play again. They had a bunch set on the left side, and Dietrich ran basically a rub route with Stahlbaumer. Stahlbaumer rubbed off of Dietrich. Dietrich went to the inside. Stahlbaumer went to the outside. and their back got confused, threw it up. Dietrich jumped up in the air and just brought the ball down in the end zone.
So now Hanover for the two-point conversion. They strike, which is 36 seconds to go before halftime. They took just a minute and 1 second to score on that series. The coach, we're both right. Their defense and offense both explosive. Carter Bruna takes the pitch, now makes the throw. Back to Bruna, his brother, who scored. Wow, they have some trickiness to them, too.
That was, I think they work at that at home, because I tell you what, that was a pretty much a timing play, because he hands off to Carter, and Carter just kind of says, I'm going to take him on the outside, and Carter takes two steps back, waits for Will to get in the end zone, throws it low enough, but I think he was trying to make Will work for it, because Will was trying to take the ball away from last time, so I think there's some brother rivalry going on. Like I was telling them up here in the stand, up here in the booth, I think there might be some discussion of this game over Thanksgiving dinner.
There you go. They'll have a lot to talk about, especially in this first half. So much is taking place in this first half. It was Dietrich with a 7-yard touchdown catch from quarterback Will Bruna, who's had a great first half. 3 touchdown passes, just 1 interception. That's the only turnover so far in this game for Hanover, and that really has been the story, turnovers. The Dietrich, a 7-yard touchdown reception, and then Will Bruna, a 2-point touchdown reception catch of his own from his brother, Carter. And speaking of Carter, he will kick it off for the Wildcats, and we'll keep it right here, Bernie, which is 36 seconds to go before halftime. 34-14, Hanover's lead has grown to 20. As you mentioned, they'll get the football to start the second half. Here's the approach. The right-footed straightaway kicker boots this one short. Boots able to pick it up on the bounce, working his way off the right side, and he is brought down at the 25-yard line with 32 seconds to go before the half.
Yeah, this is a big one for Dighton. They've got to get a score here, or, like I said, Hanover gets the ball to start the second half. Hanover gets a big hold right here. They can also get a big hold with the defensive stop here, too. So this is a big time for Dighton. Try to get some mojo back on their side, the emotion back swinging their way. But Hanover right now is just doing a great job. Great job of subbing. I've seen more players play in this game than I have the last 3 times I've seen them play. And it's playing a really team defense type of game.
It is 1st and 10 here for Dighton at the 25-yard line. Now back to Ling. Ling meets Carlos Emmanuel. He brings him down for a loss.
You know, I talked to you about earlier how they didn't think about a quarterback draw or a draw play there, but Carlos Emmanuel just sniffed it out like it was supper coming. And I tell you what, he just did a great job. He was right there and ate that up.
Loss of 3 yards. And that will just be the final play of the first half. Hanover closes the first half on a 34-8 run. They lead at the half 34-14. The big stat of the first half, Dighton, 4 turnovers, Hanover's 1, and that is the difference in this game. 34-14 our score at the half. Hanover, 2 quarters away from reaching the top again and picking up their 4th state championship in school history. Halftime show next here on KCLY 100.9.
If you're in the ag business, you need a financial partner that understands it. We have years of ag business experience, but we make an extra effort to get to know your operation. We make all our loan decisions locally and even offer on-farm visits to learn your business firsthand. We know ag business, your business. Citizen State Bank, Marysville, Waterville, and Hanover. Member FDIC.
We're just making a
Kramer Oil Company goes the extra mile to serve the fuel needs of the area farmers. They specialize in bulk delivery of diesel fuel and gasoline to Washington, Marshall, Riley, and Clay counties. Having fuel delivered to your farm site or field and to your mobile fuel tanks while you're busy working goes above and beyond the usual fuel delivery service. Visit their website, KramerOil.com, that's KramerOil.com, or give Kramer Oil Company a call toll-free at 800-498-2466.
For over 65 years, Hanover Electric has served the area with all their electrical, plumbing, heating, and air conditioning needs. They appreciate the support they've received from the local area year after year and the friends they've made along the way. Hanover Electric is proud to welcome new clientele and look forward to many years of working together. They will continue to provide excellent service to the community. Hanover Electric keeps everything running efficiently.
If you're inspired to throw the best party for a friend, an anniversary, dinner for your employees, or any other special occasion that calls for delicious food, Ricky's Cafe in Hanover has you covered. They offer catering services in the entire KCLY listing area with competitive prices. Give them a call and see what's on the menu for your big event. Catering is a solution for feeding large groups of people, and Ricky's Cafe knows how to make mouths water. Ricky's Cafe in Hanover, catering to all your celebrations.
At Sapp Brothers, they pride themselves on the high level of service they provide and their ability to meet their customers' special fueling needs. From bulk gasoline and diesel to propane and oil delivery, Sapp Brothers is a fuel source to residents and businesses alike in Marshall and Washington counties. They can deliver a variety of bulk fuels to where you need it, at your home or out in the field. Contact them for a competitive fuel quote. Call their Hanover office at 337-2446.
When you need maintenance service or repair for your vehicle, how can you be sure you're choosing a professional repair facility? One you can count on for excellent service, integrity, and dependability. One way is to visit Floyd's Auto Repair, an auto-valued service center. They offer complete general automotive repairs and represent the best of the best with top quality parts and reliable certified techs. From a simple oil change to engine overhauls, rely on Floyd's Auto Repair, your auto value service center in Hanover.
And welcome back to the halftime show here. And we're at Fisher Field in Newton. A very happy halftime as Hanover is up in this football game 34-14. And just looking back at the game, it's really all about the turnovers. As Dighton, things started so well for them in this football game. They get a great kickoff return on the opening series of the game as Booz takes it to the Hanover 31-yard line. They end up scoring on a quarterback run from Tyler Ling on fourth down. He scores on a 4-yard run, and they take a 6-0 advantage at that point. Hanover then goes 3-and-out on their first possession. And by the way, Dighton scores. That was at the 8:40 mark of the first quarter. Hanover goes 3-and-out. Dighton gets back the football, but that's when things start to unravel a little bit for them offensively. As again, they had 4 turnovers. They throw an interception. That's coming up with the pickoff. That was Stahlbaumer, the first of his 2 interceptions. And then Hanover would score to tie up the game as Dietrich would score on a 3rd-and-8 play from the 25-yard line of Dighton on a 25-yard touchdown catch, tie up the game at 6 apiece. As the conversion try would be no good. Dighton then would turn over the football again, this time a fumble. And it would be Darvin Nischke with the fumble recovery. Hanover would get it at the Dighton 16-yard line, and Fridgie would score on a 4th-down play. It was 4th-and-7 from the 13-yard line. He would score on the 13-yard touchdown catch from quarterback Will Bruna. And that would make it 14-6 after the 2-point conversion. Dighton, though, they would put things back together on their 4th series, and I'm sorry on that last series for Hanover, I didn't have who scored that 2-point conversion for the Wildcat. Will Bruce in the pass from Carter. Oh, no, I'm talking about when Fritchie scored their 2nd touchdown. For some reason, I didn't get that marked down, who scored the 2-point conversion for the Wildcats that time. So, but they did get it on that one. Ring a bell. They only had 2.
Oh, it's a drag pass with a number 25.
Oh, you're right. It was Darvin Ishke.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet.
That's why I have you.
My memory's not too good, but it's good enough.
Yeah, he was wide open. I do remember it, too.
On the east end here.
Good memory, Coach. That made it 14-6 at the time. That was at 3:47 mark of the first quarter with a lot of action in that first quarter. Dighton then put together a long drive. Let him play 65 yards in 6 minutes, and it was Kramer on a 22-yard touchdown catch. Booth added the 2-point conversion, and Dighton would tie up the game at 14-all, and that was with 10:13 to go in the first half. They would not score again. They would have multiple more turnovers in the game, and just after they had tied it, Hanover had a quick answer of their own, and Carter Bruna would score on a 3-yard run, and a big play of the drive came on a 3rd-and-10 at their own 15. Dietrich, a 61-yard reception. Carter Bruna would score on a 3-yard run That was with 8:38 to go before halftime to make it. That made it 20-14 in favor of Hanover. Two teams would exchange turnovers in. Stahlbaumer had an interception, but then Blair Hoffman had an interception, and then there would be three consecutive turnovers. Kenton Dietrich then would have another interception for Hanover, and this time Hanover would cash in once again, and they would score in just 45 seconds. Atkins, the big play of the drive, 46-yard catch. Carter Bruno would score in a three-yard run, and that would make it 26-14. The two-point conversion try was no good. Hanover then would score their final touchdown, which is 36 seconds left. Dietrich, a 7-yard touchdown reception. And then Will Bruna would get the two-point conversion catch from his brother, Carter Bruna. And that leaves us where we stand right now at 34-14. And, Coach, it's a little bit longer halftime than you would find in normal playoff circumstances or the regular season.
Well, it's just power. It's just entertainment packed, let's put it that way. It's 20-minute halftime. But we've got the Dighton band that was out here playing, and we've got the Hanover cheerleaders doing a routine right now, and then we have the Dighton cheerleaders come back out, and they're going to do a routine also. So it's just like the Super Bowl, you know. We've got the top-notch entertainment at halftime.
So again, our score is 34-14, Hanover on top of Dighton. We'll come back with some team stats and individual stats from the first half, unofficial numbers that I put together for you. That's coming up again, 34-14, Hanover two quarters away from their fourth state title here in Newton over Dighton. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
The Hanover Hospital and Warren Clinic is ready to protect your family's health care needs. From newborns to seniors and everyone in between, they are committed to delivering high-quality care. Addressing the health needs ranging from prevention, checkups, and care of illnesses and injury to maternity and other health conditions, they take pride in those they serve. Join Hanover Hospital and Warren Clinic in cheering on the student-athletes of the community in their academic and sporting events. They're proud of the Hanover Wildcats.
BNW Electric in Hanover is your local electrical specialist, and they're ready to meet your residential or commercial needs. They can handle rewiring jobs, installations, new construction, and more. Rest assured, the work will get done right the first time by professionals who know the job. BNW Electric is ready to handle any project that requires a backhoe. Keep them in mind for all your electrical needs and backhoe service. BNW Electric, proud fans and huge supporters of the Hanover Wildcats.
Bruna Implement, your local Case IH dealer, is excited about the success of the area's high school athletes as they wind down the season. Watching them become not only better athletes, but better young men is the most rewarding thing to see. The love they have for the game, the commitment to the team, and the pride in their schools shows in what they bring to the field. Congratulations to all the area high school teams making it to the postseason playoffs. Bruna Implement, your Case IH dealer, is extremely proud of you.
It's not too early to book your holiday party, so make out your guest list and set the date. Landau Lanes is the perfect place for your holiday party this year. Their conference center can accommodate small and large groups, whether it's a family get-together or a business event. You provide the guests and the party atmosphere. Landau Lanes will provide the venue and delicious food and drinks that you'll need for a fantastic party. Don't be naughty. Book your holiday party now at Landau Lanes in Marysville.
One field at a time. It's the promise that started it all back in 1946 and is still true today for Lewis Hybrids. From innovative products to their field-by-field placement decisions and replant program, you get more than just seed. You get personalized service that can help you reach your profit potential. Lewis Hybrids and Shaley Seed consider it a privilege to be your partner for success. One field at a time. Visit lewishybrids.com or contact your local Lewis dealer, Roger Shaley of Hanover, by calling 713-2336.
Jones Trash Service provides residential and commercial waste pickup in Washington County. Their service is affordable, dependable, and professional. Jones Trash Service also offers roll-off containers to support your special projects. Whether it's renovation, cleanup, roof replacement, or yard clearing, they'll deliver the containers to you when you need it and remove it when your job is complete. Contact them for quotes for home or business trash service if you're not already on their route. Jones Trash Service of Washington.
Innovation. It doesn't always come easy, but it's always worth the struggle. We at Blue Valley Telecommunications understand how important innovation is to technology. As we look back on the past 60 years, we see how we've transformed telephone service through cables strung on fence posts to telephone, TV, and even high-speed internet over state-of-the-art fiber optic cables. As your technology provider, we're proud to have served you for the past 60 years and look forward to continuing to do that for years to come.
And welcome back to Fisher Field here in Newton. It is Hanover on top, 34-14, our score at the break as they are taking on Dighton today. Some unofficial team numbers for you. Hanover getting it done through the air. They have 231 yards at halftime, 227 through the air, just 4 on the ground. And I have Will Brunet, as far as throwing the football, I have him 12 of 15 for 227 yards, 3 touchdowns, and just the 1 interception. A lot of guys catching the football for him. I have 7 different receivers with catches in that first half for the Wildcats. Kevin Dietrich for the most yardage, 2 catches for 86 yards in the first half for Hanover. On the other side of things, Dighton had them with just 151 yards of total offense in the first half, 32 on the ground, 119 yards through the air, and Tyler Ling, I had him 11 of 17. Again, these are unofficial numbers for 119 yards. No touchdowns, 3 interceptions. And, Coach, they've been able to run the football a little bit. Tyler Ling, things are happening to them that normally don't happen. I mean, Ling is their leading rusher. That's not what they want. That hasn't, to my knowledge, been the case all season, or at least you look at the stats, you wouldn't believe that would be the case in any of their games. 9 carries for 39 yards. Lake Lewis has not been able to get going for them. He came in as their leading ground gainer, 700 yards rushing, but more impressively, almost 9 yards per carry. He has 4 carries for 3 yards. Ling, you know, I thought that would be advantage Hanover, that they're a team that relies on the pass. Sure, he has 119 yards. He's thrown for a pretty high percentage, but 0 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. He came in with a 43-4 number. That's 43 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. So he has thrown almost as many interceptions today as he has the whole season.
Well, that's based on Hanover, their defense. They've done some switching, like I said. They've done a lot. They put some quickness up on their defensive end with Fritchie. They moved Fritchie out of the cornerback area and moved Atkins in. They've taken Staubomber and Dietrich and put them on the same side as they have on the same side as they have this year, because they've noticed they're throwing more towards the right. And, you know, and they've basically taken Ling and just said, okay, if you're going to beat us, Dighton, Ling is going to beat us. That's the only guy that's going to beat us. They've shut everybody else down, and that's what's helped Hanover do so well. And up front, Carlos Manuel, he's shut off the middle. He's gone from guard to guard and just owned that real estate on the inside during the line. And you and I know, both know, as the season progresses, your line play is so important, and that's what controls the game.
34-14, our score here at the break. We'll be back with second half action. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
For any concrete project you need for a residential driveway, basement, patio, or curb, you can count on Midwest Products to handle it. At every level of the job, you'll find a dedicated, skilled crew prepared to deliver a professional job. With state-approved plants in Hanover, Clay Center, Lynn, and Washington, they can meet the needs of residential, commercial, or farm-related projects. For other ready-mix concrete work, give Midwest Products a call at 800-371-2252.
If you're inspired to throw the best party for a friend, an anniversary, dinner for your employees, or any other special occasion that calls for delicious food, Ricky's Cafe in Hanover has you covered. They offer catering services in the entire KCLY listing area with competitive prices. Give them a call and see what's on the menu for your big event. Catering is a solution for feeding large groups of people, and Ricky's Cafe knows how to make mouths water. Ricky's Cafe in Hanover, catering to all your celebrations.
At Sapp Brothers, they pride themselves on the high level of service they provide and their ability to meet their customers' special fueling needs. From bulk gasoline and diesel to propane and oil delivery, Sapp Brothers is a fuel source to residents and businesses alike in Marshall and Washington counties. They can deliver a variety of bulk fuels to where you need it, at your home or out in the field. Contact them for a competitive fuel quote. Call their Hanover office at 337-2446.
When you need maintenance service or repair for your vehicle, how can you be sure you're choosing a professional repair facility? One you can count on.
for excellent service, integrity, and dependability. One way is to visit Floyd's Auto Repair, an auto-valued service center. They offer complete general automotive repairs and represent the best of the best with top quality parts and reliable certified techs. From a simple oil change to engine overhauls, rely on Floyd's Auto Repair, your auto-value service center in Hanover.
Are you tired of wondering where your certified wheat came from? Or are you tired of overpaying for new seed wheat? Oldie Seed is offering their direct buying program on new certified wheat seed. With the downturn in the wheat prices, Oldie Seed understands the struggles growers go through when making new purchase decisions. Call Oldie Seed today to book your direct seed purchases at $8.70 per unit and premium full seed treatment for $4.50. Call Oldie Seed today, where they have your back.
As you prepare your Thanksgiving feast, remember, Ray's Apple Market can help. Their deli and bakery have plenty of breads and pies, a variety of signature Rock House salads, and meat, cheese, and veggie trays to nibble on. Plus, with their in-store Hickory Pit smoked boneless turkeys, you're guaranteed to have the best-tasting turkey ever. Then, with the food on the table, take a moment to look around at all the precious blessings you have to be thankful for. Ray's Apple Market will be closed Thanksgiving Day, but open the night before until 10.
I was working on an order when in walked Radar. Can I...
Help me? I hope so. I have requisitions for office supplies and heard you're the best around.
Well, I don't want to...
Brag. I know.
But we have...
The Laurel Managerial Mid-Back Chair for $179? I'll take two.
How about the...
Business Source Recycled File Folders, Rubber Bands, and Adhesive Notes? I'll take one of each.
Perfect. I appreciate...
My business? You're welcome. Central Office Service and Supply Guy, you're...
I know. I'm the best.
No matter what your age, a new toy is always exciting. And Radio Shack inside Patterson's Health Mart has toys and electronics for all ages. Video games and cell phones, cameras and camcorders, TVs and DVD players. If that's not enough, laptops and netbooks, iPods and MP3 players, GPS navigation, and lots of electronic accessories. There's too much to mention here, so come into Radio Shack for the gifts everyone loves to receive inside Patterson's Health Mart Pharmacy in downtown Clay Center.
You must prepare for tomorrow and make ready the fields for next spring. At Wilbur Ellis Read, Seed, and Feed, we're not psychic, we don't read palms or cast spells, but we do read fields, see what works, and offer you the products we know will help with your profit potential. We start with cleaning up the weeds, adding residual for control into the spring, and apply fall fertilizer with or without stabilizers for a head start to next year's crop. No magic, just simple, straightforward solutions. We are Wilbur Ellis, Reed, Seed, and Feed.
And welcome back to Fisher Field here in Newton. Trim Sanchez alongside my partner, Tim Klein, back in studio. Bernie Fancella bringing this broadcast of Hanover State Championship football, and hopefully we'll be talking a state championship here within, well, perhaps a little over an hour, as Hanover up 34-14. Hanover with three state championships in their school history. Just looking back, if you want to go down memory lane for a moment, 1979, they defeated Douglas in 2A, 6-0, and then they went back-to-back in 2008, 2009, Division II, 2008, 46-14 over Victoria, and then 2009, defeated Bushton Kavira Heights 66-36. They're trying to win for the fourth time in school history. This is their third straight appearance, losing the last couple of years in Division I to Central Plains in 2014 and last year to Spearville. Now, the other game, again, coming up today after this one, it's Osborne undefeated against St. Francis undefeated. They will play at 3:30. And we know just a little bit about those teams that we covered St. Francis last year because we were covering Solomon, so we got to see them play one time, and that would have been in the quarterfinals, I believe that was, in Solomon. And then Osborne, we didn't cover them, but we covered Dickinson County, and they defeated Burlingame last week 62-16. And Burlingame, that's impressive to me because Burlingame was in the same district that Harrington, Rural Vista out of Dickinson County that we cover, that they're in, and Burlingame just obliterated people. Clifton Clyde was in that district, which folks around Clay Center and Hanover know a little bit about Clifton Clyde. So it was an impressive win for Osborne. So I don't know who's going to win that one. It should be a great game.
Yeah. Well, you look at St. Francis when they get off the bus, they're pretty impressive. Their coach was from Colorado originally. He coached six-man football there, which that's becoming a little bit of a league out there in Western Kansas too. But you know, Saney is, you know, like I said, another NWKL team like Dighton is, and you know, that's Northwest Kansas, and they've been, of course, they beat Spearville to get where they are. So and Spearville in that game was what I heard. They could have gone either way, but Spearville had three turnovers and ended up losing the game to St. Francis because of their turnovers. So, you know, turnovers are a big thing, especially at 8-man. It's such a quicker game.
So that game is coming up at 3:30, and it's actually turning out to be a nice day. I'm using my cell phone, so I can't access what the temperature is right now. But, Coach, regardless what the temperature is, it just this morning, I mean, I saw a guy walking his dog with coveralls, and right now, you don't need that. It's not too bad at all out.
No, and compared to yesterday, okay, we're talking yesterday being 24, 25 mile an hour wind the whole day, just freezing all day. And then the day before that, the wind was tremendously. I talked to a guy from Sublette, Kansas, talking Western Kansas a little bit. They had a dust devil out there, a dust devil, with 80 to 90 mile an hour wind and knocked their electricity out for an hour and a half. So
wow.
It's the wind. There's no wind here today. No wind. The flag is just drooped down, dead, and a perfect sunshine day. What a great day for football here in basically South Central Kansas.
Well, I don't want to get too dramatic here, but Hanover, they're going to get the football to start the second half up 34-14. If they can score here on this opening drive with all their experience behind them, they are who they are. And I think when you're Hanover, you step onto the field, you're going to have maybe a touchdown advantage anyways because of your history. Dighton, if they allow them to score, I think in the back of their heads, they're going to be saying, oh, it could be ball game.
Yeah, like I said, the thing that Hanover's done, you know, is that they've limited everybody else, and they've said, okay, if you're going to beat us, then Mr. Ling, you're going to beat us. And so far, he has struggled with that.
Yeah, that is the big story again, turnovers. Tyler Ling came in with 43 touchdowns and four interceptions. He had no touchdowns today, zero. And he has three interceptions, four total turnovers for Dighton, and a fumble also. Hanover just with the one interception thrown by Will Bruna. And, you know, part of it on that possession, he was backed up near his own end zone, and I think that just made him a little bit jittery. So Hanover will get the football in wide, going left to right, kicking off will be Logan Ling. Here's the approach and the kick. His kick angling out of bounds, and it will go out of bounds for the second time on Logan Ling.
On a kickoff. And Hanover would have a re-kick it probably because Hanover wants to get the ball and advance as far as they can. The penalty will only put them at the 25-yard line. They would really like to start up around the 30 to 40-yard line, which would be about midfield.
So Logan Lang will try it again. He's a 6'1", 220-pound junior. Has a giant cast on his right arm. Right hand, I should say. But he is a gamer. He is out there. This one, a squib kick right down the middle of the field. Atkins had trouble with it. Had it dropped it. Has to pick it back up. And there he goes, running off the left side. And he runs out of bounds just across the 20-yard line.
Yeah, you think of the advantage at time when you fumble around like that, that maybe more holes would open up. But Dighton did a really good job of filling their lanes, coming down the field on their kickoff return, and basically filled it up. And it's still good for field position for Hanover to start at. They have definitely had worse field position to start at today.
Yeah, definitely. When they took it over, and that's when he did turn over the football, they started that drive clear back at their 1-yard line. Their only turnover on that series. First and 10 at the 23-yard line here for the Wildcat. Here's a snap back to Will Bruna. Retreat, pressure, throws, completes the stall bomber. Broken tackle. And stall bomber fumbled it, but he's able to get back on top of it at the 31-yard line. A little bit scary there. 8-yard pass play.
Yeah. Will Bruna was in the grasp of the defender. At the time, it was the younger Ling brother, Logan. And he got the ball away and got stall bomber. Stall bomber went down the field a little bit, dropped the ball, picked it back up. Got on top of it.
Second down and a long two. Football at the 31-yard line. Football in the far hash, out of the gun. Bruno with a back to his left. That back is Dietrich. On the option, he keeps the football. Cuts inside of a would-be tackler and gets forced out. All that, and he picks up yardage to the 33-yard line. So a gain of a couple there, but not sure that he got enough for the first down. Doesn't look like he did. Actually, they're going to actually spot that ball at the 32-yard line, so just a gain of one for Will Bruna.
Be third and one. It's a good position, good play, and that was a good thing to try to keep, you know, Dighton off their off balance, so to speak, and keep him unbalanced there. Believe
Bruna easily gets it now, busting free off the left side, and there he goes. You see the speed of Will Bruna, but he will be caught. Dighton with some speed too. That was Dalton Hoffman who got to him,
and we have a late hit. We have a flag on the play. There's a late hit on Dighton. Looks like the guy piled on top of Bruna, and the referees are on top of that and protected him. It's going to be a penalty against Dighton.
We'll see where they mark it. He went down to the 17-yard line. So a gain of 30 yards on that run for quarterback Will Bruna, the biggest run gain of the game for Hanover.
That's going to be a personal foul against Dighton. It's going to be half the way to the distance to the goal line, and that is huge. And I just think, Will, if he would have kept on running instead of stopping and trying to juke the guy, he would have outran the guy and had a touchdown.
Most teams he's going to score, but Dighton does have some good speed.
They're inside the 10-yard line of Dighton right now.
First and goal at the 8-yard line after the penalty. Counterplay, left side, Dietrich. Dietrich spinning ahead, and he's able to drag the defender into the end zone for the touchdown. What a run.
That was just great. I mean, once again, you know, they're using the Thunder-Lightning connection here again. I like to call it that because you got Carter Bruna, who's the Thunder, and you got Dietrich, who's the Lightning, and all of a sudden he just is spinning back, top back, and he just spins his way right into the end zone that time. What a great run that time. What a great mismatch and a misdirection play that time by Hanover.
Well, here's the scary thing, Coach, is Hanover is getting their ground game going. So now they take a 40-14 lead with 10:47 to go in the third quarter. Carter Bruna motioning here to the near right side of the formation. Snap back to Will Bruna. Bruna looking right, making the throw, tries to force it into Dietrich. Incomplete, but a flag down as that ball was thrown between both Dalton Hoffman and Blair Hoffman, the twin.
Yeah, I think there was a pass interference on Dighton that one because they were just all over him like white on rice. It was terrible.
And they are twin brothers, both sophomores.
Yeah, Hanover's getting another chance right here, and Will will get his pass up, but he had to throw it low because they were just cloaked on him like a trench coat.
Well, now the penalty's starting to mount. That's three penalties already here in the second half for Dighton. They only have three in the entire first half. Hanover will try the two-point conversion again. They lead 40-14 with 10:47 to go third quarter. Will Bruna trying to run it up the middle himself. Does he get in? He does. Easily gets in. Does Will Bruna for the two-point conversion run?
The penalty helped him there. Got him halfway to the goal line, which gives him 1 yard. So that was just a great call right there, Wade, and allows Will Bruna to score a touchdown in the state championship ball game.
10:47 to go third quarter. Hanover picks up where they left off in the first half. They lead 42-14. You're listening to Hanover Wildcat Football on KCLY 100.9.
Even if the tailpipe on your combine is still warm, it's time to place next year's seed order. Central Valley Ag has a financing plan you need to look at.
0% seed financing until January 15th of 2018.
CBA Seed Director Chad Udbuddy is also offering price discounts, even if you make changes later.
We're giving a discount on the dollars that you are submitting an order for today.
It's easy to order from Central Valley Ag. Get details at cbacoop.com.
Our story is pretty simple. It's still being written. And we believe in where it's going with our employees and our families. Fall is here. It's a new season. A perfect opportunity to do something new. Something bold. Our employees are writing that story with us. They are getting the important things that they need, like top pay, home time with their families, and more. Truck drivers are the lifeblood of our economy and the pulse of our company. What's your story? We are TSI Kansas Incorporated of Clay Center.
24.
And welcome back here. It's 10:41 to go in the third quarter. 42-14 Hanover with the score. And it was Foos on the return for Dighton. And he takes it out to the 24-yard line. That last drive series for Hanover, four plays, 57 yards in the time of 106. Dietrich, an 8-yard touchdown run. Bruna, the 2-point conversion run. So Dighton starts at their 24-yard line with 10:41 to go here in this third quarter. Throw out to the far side right. One of those Hoffman twins with the catch. That one, Dalton Hoffman with a reception out across the 30-yard line.
Yeah, and Atkins was right there to make the tackle, but he was a little bit off of him too far, and the defensive coach over there from Hanover is telling him, you got to be up closer on him. You can't let him have that much room. And Foose, but the hard thing is that Foose is an athlete. He's a senior, and you're looking against playing his defense against a sophomore, Mr. Atkins himself.
Gain of 7, 2nd and 3 at the 31-yard line here for Dighton. 2 minutes gone by in the second half. Hanover has already scored 8 points. Here's a pass over the middle. It's going to be incomplete, and the pass thrown to Dalton Poppin. Darvinisky came in there to break it up. No flag initially, and then the back judge, maybe some pressure, Ron Tenbrink, heard the sideline, and there came the flag. Or make that the referee.
Yeah, that was a... He threw that flag about 25 yards, so, I mean, he's got a pretty good arm on him, too, but I thought that was contact was the same time, same place. I didn't see much interference on that one, but he saw something. He must have saw the hand wrapped around him from the backside or something.
So that is the first penalty of the second half on Hanover, and just their 4th penalty of the game. So that moves the football now up to the 34-yard line of Hanover. It's 1st and 10 at the Wildcat 34-yard line. 10-3 to go here, 3rd quarter, 42-14, Wildcats on top. Lane throwing over the middle. It's going to be caught by Food. Food should have a 1st down inside of the 25-yard line. Looks like he went down right at the 1st down marker. Got 11, needed 10, 1st down.
And the wideout was watching the offensive lineman block there on Fritzy because that was pretty close to holding. So they're getting a lot of pressure on Ling right now, but he's making the completions. He's staying in the pocket and being strong. Dighton's making a nice little drive right here.
1st and 10 at the 23-yard line of Hanover here for Dighton. Hanover up big, 42-14, state championship game. Ling going through its progression, makes the throw. It's going to be behind his intended target, Hoffman. Same type of play where the flag was thrown earlier. This time, no flag. Good defense there by Zarbaneski.
Yeah, he just was all over that one, the monster by Zarbaneski was. He had the drag route across the middle there, and he just stepped up and knocked it down.
42-14. Hanover in control here. 2nd and 10 for the Dighton Hornets at the Hanover 23-yard line. Win not bad today. Yesterday, a whole different story. That really would have caused problems for Dighton. And you could say Hanover, too. Hanover threw a lot in the first half. Here's a throw over to Hoffman, far side. Makes the catch, has another 1st down.
There's a mismatch in the understanding of the coverage that time between Zarbaneski and Atkins because they were both going to the middle instead of one staying on the outside. That's what allowed Foose to be open.
And that pass and catch, ball taken inside of the 10-yard line. Pass play of 14 yards. So now it's 1st and goal at the 9-yard line here for the Dighton Hornets. Ling, pressured right. Emmanuel can't hold on him. Here's a throw. It's going to be tipped and incomplete. Dietrich got a hand on it. He had Foose in the area. Also had another target there as well. But Foose, Lake Lewis, who was also there, but Foose was the intended target, but it was broken up.
Stop bombers over the top on that playing defense. That was a much better defensive call with the D-backs that time for Hanover. And also, Lane's getting some more pressure from up front there. He had to throw the ball a little bit quicker than he wants. So he had some happy feet when he was doing it. Wasn't quite set to throw as well as he has been the last two possessions.
5 plays, all passes for Dighton on this drive. 2nd and goal at the 9-yard line. Here's a throw, and Atkins, a one-handed interception in the end zone. Are you kidding me? He went up and brought it down with one hand, stuck up that right hand and brought it down. The pass was intended for David Kramer.
I think he's a basketball player because he went up and just caught that thing with the one hand and just like a rebound, just ripped it down and tucked it in. So, the thing is, I wish he would have just stayed in the end zone instead of just bringing it out, but at least they're starting in a better place. They're starting about the 3-yard line compared to the 6-inch line. Now, I say that, but the last time it happened, they had a penalty to put them back to the 6-inch line. So let's just keep it calm and take it down the field here, Hanover, and score another touchdown.
Ling had 4 interceptions the whole season. The whole season coming into this game. Well, that is interception number 4 here today. Here's Will Bruna, shotgun snap, running off the right side, cuts back. Picks up short yardage. Now, I couldn't find how many fumbles they had coming into this game. That was not on max prep. But I was told by somebody in the crowd, unofficially, I was told they had 5 total turnovers, so the 4 interceptions, just 1 fumble, which makes sense because they don't run a lot. But they have 5 total turnovers today. If it's true, that's as much as they had the whole season. That's impressive. That was a 2-yard gain by Bruno, by the way.
You know, you really worked the crowd today, Trent. I mean, you really worked the crowd going through and finding out information. You're as friendly as a Western Kansas guy.
There you go. And Dietrich with the football, and he is surrounded, and he goes down. Blake Lewis and others in on that tackle. No gain. It's going to be third and long.
I mean, he didn't really go down. He just had to blow it dead because he just would not go down. And so they had to blow it dead or else somebody would have got hurt. So it's third down long for Hanover. But if they get a first down here, it would really help things out a lot.
Well, the interesting thing about it, talking about meeting people in the crowd, it was a Dighton fan from Abilene, where I'm from, a guy we both know very well. That's a prominent businessman, and I didn't know he's from Dighton. He has kids that are athletes there in Abilene. Third and 8 from the 4-yard line. Here's a throw. It's going to be tipped. Uh-oh, and it's going to fall incomplete. That hung up in the air. It seemed like forever. Thankfully, Dighton was not able to pick that off.
Yeah, that was tipped by their defensive lineman, Isaac Torson, number 33. He had his hand up in the air. The pressure was put on by Logan Ling, number 40. He got that club, but it wasn't the end that knocked it down. It was 33. Isaac Torson.
And now fourth down, Hanover. Likely to punt here. And their punter is their quarterback, Will Bruna. Who's dropping back late here. He stands just around the 35-yard line. Here is the kick from Will Bruna. Who's watches it in, takes it for 37, working his way to the far side of the field. Richie can't tackle him. He's slick. And finally, he's taken down by Carter Bruna. Inside of the 20-yard line.
Now, he's definitely got some tools, I'll tell you what he does. He's got some speed. He's hard to bring down. He's very compact. Both their backs in the way of Foose and Lake Lewis are very compact runners, and they're just very talented.
Yeah, Foose is really good. I mean, they have some really good players. It just shows you how good Hanover is this year. Dighton is not short of talent.
Yeah, Foose is their tight end. He's not just their running back.
He's their backup quarterback. Yeah, that's exactly what the coach told me when I was talking to him. He said he can play his multiple positions. Here, the throw is going to be tipped. Kevin Dietrich came up on it. It was intended for Lake Lewis, but Dietrich had a shot at it.
Yeah, and Emmanuel was the one that tipped it. He got his hands up. Really good defensive line play there by Hanover. So in the last three plays, they've had two hugely tipped passes by the defensive lineman who's got their hands up.
So now second down and 10 at the 18-yard line of Hanover, 7:21 to go here, third quarter, 42-14, Hanover up. Trips left, that's the near wide side of the field for quarterback Tyler Lang. Takes the shotgun snap, looks left. And Carlos Emmanuel grabbed him and couldn't quite bring him down all the way. And finally, he gets sacked by Austin Gakel. And as you talked about earlier, and there's a hold call there against Dighton, but as you talked about earlier, a good point about the depth, and we talked about depth being a factor, but credit to Matt Hoyer and his staff. They're using kids, names we haven't been mentioning in the last several weeks. He's using everybody here today. I mean, you go back to Atkins. I haven't mentioned Atkins' name very much since I've been covering him.
Or Gickley, the one, because they're just good kids. I mean, they're athletic. I mean, this shows Hanover's depth once again. So they got 25 players out, and Dighton's got 14. You know, those six guys over here have been standing on the sideline quite a bit. And that's going to be wearing. And as the game goes on, that's going to be very important when it comes to Hanover and Dighton. And that's a huge penalty right there against Dighton.
That backs them up. It's second down and 27 at the 34-yard line of Hanover. Twins right. One receiver to left-hand side of the formation. Shotgun snack. Ling moving to his right. Here's a throw here over to the near side. It's going to be caught by Lewis. Lewis gets caught from behind by Fritchie. Boy, that's a big tackle by Fritchie. We've said his name a lot. He doesn't make that tackle. Who knows where he ends up?
Like I said, he has been truly the X factor, I think, this whole game today with the way he's been playing defense. Just once again, and what we're seeing right now is a factor I talked about earlier. Lewis goes down. He's got an ankle injury, looks like, possibly. We're bringing in a trainer right now. And if he goes down, it just lessens Dighton's potentness on offense and defense both. But Fritchie wants to think, again, he busy man. They saw the pass play coming. They saw the screen coming. And Hanover backs up, plays great defense, kind of plays up in a zone kind of like area, and Fritchie just caught it from behind.
We have a timeout on the field with an injured player. 6:46 to go, third quarter, and it is Lake Lewis of Dighton down. 42-14, the lead for the Wildcats. You're listening to State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
You work hard to earn your cash. You shouldn't have to work hard to get a cash back rebate. Now you don't have to with the Titan Stash Your Cash program. Save instantly when you purchase American-made Titan Goodyear Farm tires now through December 31st. No forms to fill out, no phone calls to make. Just stash your cash. See your Farmers Cooperative Tire Branch today for complete details.
Investing in our own success.
If you're in the ag business, you need a financial partner that understands it. We have years of ag business experience, but we make an extra effort to get to know your operation. We make all our loan decisions locally and even offer on-farm visits to learn your business firsthand. We know ag business, your business. Citizen State Bank, Marysville, Waterville, and Hanover. Member FDIC.
We're just making a
And Lake Lewis of Dighton getting some help over to his bench. Dighton's bench is right beneath us, right here on the near side of the field. All the Hanover fans sitting across from us across the stadium and the Hanover sideline across the field from us. A nice group of Hanover fans have made the trip today. 42-14 our score. Hanover on top. 6:46 to go here at third quarter. It is Dighton football. Third down 17 at the Hanover 26-yard line. They're going right to left in black and orange, east to west as we view it here. From this stadium, it is Fisher Field in Newton.
Little shout out to the training corps here. I heard they were from McPherson College, and they brought their time down, and they've done 2 years of free service for the state of Kansas in the state championship eight-man games.
This is the first of two state championship games. This is the Division II state title game. You have Division I coming up at 3:30 with St. Francis and Osborne. Here's a pass completed. Hoffman makes the catch, and Hoffman will take it close to the 10-yard line, not quite 10 instead of the 15.
Yeah, good pressure that time, but the drag route, and once again, it was a delayed drag route, came from left to right that time, and he was open, and he had plenty of time to throw.
Pass play of 9 yards. And that's still not enough for a first down. And remember, they had the holding penalty, so it's 4th down and 4 at the 11-yard line.
Big play right here.
Ball on the far hash. Twins left and colliding. Booth is split in on this side, but they go to the right side. Great defensive play. Atkins again. The pass intended for David Kramer. He was open for a minute, but Atkins with those long arms, and those arms and hands have been part of the story for him here in this game, as he had the one-handed interception at the long catch earlier in the game. Right there, knocked down that pass intended for David Kramer.
Yeah, that was a great knockdown that time. This shows the length of his reach. You know, once we see him catch a one-hand interception, then we see him knock down a pass completely around the line. You almost call him as a Gumby kind of guy, because he just reaches around and stretches out before anybody can see it.
So now, Hanover gets it, 1st and 10 at the 11-yard line. Bruna pumps right. Now wants to run straight up the middle of the field, gets brought down. Isaac Torsing grabbed around his ankles and held on for Bruna, would have had a huge gain.
Yeah, that was a great huge real estate saving tackle, in fact, because, I mean, he has a lot of real estate in front of him to go.
2nd down, 6. Football just short of the 15-yard line.
But truthfully, Trent, you kind of look at this Hanover team, they're kind of showing their future here because, you know, Atkins is a sophomore, Stahlbomber's a sophomore. They're kind of showing their future here a little bit in the end of this season.
Now back to Bruna in the shotgun, looking at Dietrich now, trying to throw. Oh, my goodness, trying to throw it over the middle. It looked like the Atkins, and it was just a low throw. And an interception by Logan Lang, just a bizarre play there. Lang, he played nose guard, and that ball just seemed as a magnet right for his midsection.
Man, he just jumped up in the air just a little bit, and with that club, he just knocked it right into his hands and just clamped it like a pair of vice grips and just really held on to it. So it shows it. You know, Dighton is not giving up. They're very athletic, and they're just ready to play this game this second half.
Second interception thrown by quarterback Will Bruna. So Dighton gets back the football. They get at the Hanover 14-yard line with 5:35 to go here in the third quarter. Hanover up 42-14. Tyler Lane throwing over the middle. The pass is incomplete. Boy, David Kramer had it. Just couldn't hold on. Atkins in coverage. But, boy, that's about as close as it gets.
Yep. Actually, the coverage was Stahlbomber coming from the other side, so it could have been a really good sandwich here, too, but You know, Atkins has got burned once, so he's been playing really well since then.
Second and 10 at the 14-yard line, a handover here for Dighton. Kramer, who couldn't hold on, is split out to the right side. Here to the near side left, Booth in the slot. You also have next to him, Dalton Hoffman. Snap to Ling, looking left, avoiding the rush, flag down, and Tyler Ling's going to run it. And going out inside of the 10-yard line, but this could be coming back. And Isaac Torsten, the left guard, is pleading his case with the referee.
Now, he's pleading his case because Adam Fritchie had himself beat. And, I mean, Adam Fritchie just went completely underneath him. And Torsten had to grab his jersey in order to hang on. It looked like a bronc buster trying to hang on for 8 seconds. He just couldn't hold on to him. So that's definitely a good call on the back judge. I mean, on the referee that time, making that holding call.
It is holding.
Of course, is even pleading to his coach, please, I was just doing this, help me out here. And the coach goes, I don't have any more time. I'm not going to help you on it because it was just a good call.
So it is a hold, and so now Dighton, penalties have just been such an issue for them here in this second half. Second down, 26 at the 30-yard line here for the Hornets. Trips right, swing receiver to left side. That's Foos. A throw to him, and it's incomplete. He threw into double coverage. And Stahlbauer came up from his safety position to make sure the catch wasn't made. Dietrich was covering it.
Yeah, you have to. They've got two really good receivers in Hoffman and Boost right there because those guys are just elusive. They're compact. They really run their routes well. And Ling's been doing a really good job of finding them today, too. So this is another good third down, big third down play here for Hanover. And a big third down play for Dighton.
And now third down, 26 at the 30-yard line. Throw out to the right side. It's going to be the second ladder and ran to perfection. It was Dalton Hoffman who caught it and then made the pitch to Foos who scored.
That was a tremendous play. They put Hoffman out there, and Foos was calling to get open. So they came up on him, hit Hoffman. Hoffman just caught it and just threw it up in the air. Ran right underneath it and just went in for a touchdown untouched. Really good play. Good play call.
You know, you get to see these things in 8-man. I did my first 8-man game this year was Rural Vista and Stencher, and Rural Vista ran it to perfection, and that there was to perfection. So it was Hoffman to Foos on the hook and ladder. Pass thrown by Tyler Ling. Foos now with the football and the 2-point conversion on the pitch, trying to throw it back to his quarterback. Jump ball. He makes the catch. Wasn't pretty that he was able to jump up because he's 6'5 and catch that on Dietrich for the 2-point conversion.
Well, Dietrich lost the sun. The sun is in the right angle there. That football came down, and Lenny had a definite height advantage on him, that's for sure. So because Dietrich is only about 6 foot, and you're talking about a guy who's 6'5 and pretty athletic.
So 5:10 to play here in the third quarter, 42-22. Hanover with the lead. You're listening to Hanover Wildcat Football on KCLY 100.9.
Kramer Oil Company goes the extra mile to serve the fuel needs of the area farmers. They specialize in bulk delivery of diesel fuel and gasoline to Washington, Marshall, Riley, and Clay counties. Having fuel delivered to your farm site or field and to your mobile fuel tanks while you're busy working goes above and beyond the usual fuel delivery service. Visit their website, KramerOil.com, that's KramerOil.com, or give Kramer Oil Company a call toll-free at 800-498-2466.
For over 65 years, Hanover Electric has served the area with all their electrical, plumbing, heating, and air conditioning needs. They appreciate the support they've received from the local area year after year and the friends they've made along the way. Hanover Electric is proud to welcome new clientele and look forward to many years of working together. They will continue to provide excellent service to the community. Hanover Electric keeps everything running efficiently.
And the kickoff from Logan Ling, the kickoff handled by Cade Cohort, and he takes it out just across the 30-yard line on that swift kick. 5:07 to go here in the third, 42-22. Hanover with the lead. Dighton with that last drive. Three plays, 14 yards and 25 seconds. They score on the hook and ladder. It was Ling to Hoffman to Foos on the touchdown of 30 yards, and Ling a 2-point touchdown catch
from Booth. You'll get a little jawing going out there right now. There's a little motion coming off Dighton and Hanover. Will Carlos Manuel and Logan Ling were jawing in the ditch just right then. So from the 3-2-yard line, 5:07 to go, third quarter. Dietrich getting the handoff. Dietrich building up steam, 40, 35, and knocked out of bounds inside of the 35-yard line. There's your thunder and lightning again with Dietrich. He just really got good speed on the outside and turned it up, made a good cut on the off-the-guard play right then and went right side down the field for about 15 yards.
Good to see him get going, Coach, because since we've been doing their games, he really hasn't got going yet.
Not since the St. John's Tiffin game. I mean, he had a really good game that game, pretty good, but he's had a really good game today.
Yeah, and especially via the passing game. He does have a rushing touchdown, but now he's showing a well-balanced effort. Fake to the back, and Bruna trying to run it off the left side, and he takes multiple shots and gets strung out and brought down for no gain on the play.
That was just a read option to keep the ball with the quarterback and go around left end, and he spun and did a good job keeping himself upward, getting some yardage. Just, he had about a 2-yard loss there when he first got hit, and he got back to the line of scrimmage at least.
So many guys have had a good day for Hanover. People get lost even when you score 3 touchdowns, and Kevin Dietrich with the hat trick today, 2 touchdown catches, and also a touchdown run for him. Second down, 10 for Hanover, 32-yard line of Dighton. They lead 42-22 with 4:24 to go, third quarter. Option play, left side, Will Bruner running with the football. He gets twisted down inside of the 30-yard line. To the 28.
That was a good read on his part, too. He had to treat the back on the option. He saw the opening, and he just turned the corner and went up field for about 4 or 5 yards.
They're going to mark him down at the 29. So that was a gain of 3 yards for Will Bruna. Just inside of 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Third down and 7 at the 29-yard line at Dighton here for the Wildcats of Hanover. I formation behind quarterback Will Bruna. Counterplay, left side. This is Dietrich taking it off guard. Dietrich bouncing off people and just running with some authority. Takes it short of the 20 to the 21. Gain of 8
and a first down. I mean, he just lowered his shoulder and just buried his shoulder. Those two tacklers coming up on him that time on the left side and just said, hey, I'm going to take this. This is my game. This is my ball. I'm going to own this thing.
I think you're right. They're just talking about the depth. He's fresh. They ran Carter Bruna a little bit more in the first half, but now Dietrich getting his turn to run the football. Well-managed game by head coach Matt Hoyer. First and 10 of the 21-yard line here of Dighton for Hanover. Double tights, I formation behind quarterback Will Bruna. Bruna hands it off to Carter Bruna. Look, a big Carter go, just lowering the pad and picking up a first down as he ran right through Blair Hoffman. The 150-pound corner.
Do not get in front of the Peterbilt. All right, that's all they're going to say. Do not get in front of the Peterbilt. And Logan Lane got in front of the Peterbilt, and he got smoked. So I tell you what, he did not even hear. Carter even honked the horn twice, and the guy never got out of his way. He paid for it dearly.
And we have a player that's slow to get up, and that is Logan Lane. Again, he wears the cast on his hand. Not sure if that was factoring in or what, but he was in on that attempted tackle on Carter Bruna. The guy that I mentioned, Blair Hoffman, is the one that looked like he took it the worst, but Lane's doing okay now.
Yeah, Lane came off. I think they had to scrape the tire tread off of him to get run over. He got a speed bump out there almost.
First and goal at the 9-yard line of Dighton here for Hanover. Counterplay left side. Dietrich picking up an extra burst of speed. He races right into the end zone. Touchdown number 4 to match his jersey number.
Yeah, he was hit towards the 100-yard touchdown before he got touched at the 80-yard touchdown. That was a great play. He made a great cut. And he went through the line through the middle there, made a great cut, went to the left, just angled into the end zone for another Hanover touchdown.
Hanover just flat out wearing out this Dighton football team. Dietrich, 4 touchdowns, 2 touchdown catches in the first half, now 2 touchdown runs in the second half. That one, a 9-yarder. Run play right side on the 2-point conversion, and Dietrich trying to pitch it at the last second, but he was ruled down. There's a flag down on top of things.
I think we've got a hold here. Or a little block in the back or something.
Illegal formation against Hanover. Penalty declined, so the score will stay at 48-22. with 2:45 to go third quarter. Hanover on top here in the state championship game in 8-man Division II. You're listening to Hanover Football on KCLY 100.9.
If you're inspired to throw the best party for a friend, an anniversary, dinner for your employees, or any other special occasion that calls for delicious food, Ricky's Cafe in Hanover has you covered. They offer catering services in the entire KCLY listing area with competitive prices. Give them a call and see what's on the menu for your big event. Catering is a solution for feeding large groups of people, and Ricky's Cafe knows how to make mouths water. Ricky's Cafe in Hanover, catering to all your celebrations.
At SAP Brothers, they pride themselves on the high level of service they provide and their ability to meet their customers' special fueling needs. From bulk gasoline and diesel to propane and oil delivery, SAP Brothers is a fuel source to residents and businesses alike in Marshall and Washington counties. They can deliver a variety of bulk fuels to where you need it, at your home or out in the field. Contact them for a competitive fuel quote. Call their Hanover office at 337-2446.
And Dylan Foos having trouble with the Carter Bruna kickoff. Kind of lazily picked it up after he mishandled it, and then he's able to take it out to the 16-yard line. And you can't blame Dighton if their thunder's a little bit out of them right now, because they had a positive drive in which they scored, but then Hanover just comes right back and scores again. They lead 48-22. That's where the score's at right now, 48-22, with Dietrich, a 9-yard run, his fourth of the day. And again, the score stands at 48-22. So Dighton back with the football, 2:39 to go here in quarter number three. First and 10, Dighton at their own 16. Shotgun snap here to Tyler Ling. Out of the pocket as he rolls to his left, throws it downfield for Kramer. Kramer gets turned around. He stopped running, and that hurt that play from being successful as he was being covered by Zarbaniski and Stahlbomber, and you have a flag, coach.
Yeah, I think it's a holding back there in the backfield. Nope, he's waving the flag off. What happened was Emmanuel and Fritzy got tangled up, and it looked like they were being held. In fact, they just basically ran into each other. Fritzy kind of got up a little tender, but I think he's shaking it off.
Well, other Wildcats playing today, that would be the Kansas State Wildcats down in Waco against Baylor. At last check, they're tied at 14. These Wildcats are doing a little bit better here in Newton. They're up on Dighton, 48-22, with 2:31 to go in quarter three. Second and 10 for the Hornets of Dighton. They have it at their 16. Trips to the left-hand side of the formation. Shotgun snap to Ling. Ling looks left, throws left, pass caught for a first down. It's the sophomore, Dalton Hoffman, with the catch.
I'll tell you what, Ling, the quarterback, Tyler, he's playing he's just finding these guys, dropping it into holes. I've really never seen high school quarterback that can throw the touch that he has and be able to throw into the empty spaces. And this running backs and his receivers are running excellent routes right now. You can see why Titans, basically, their key to their game is passing offensively.
They're a very good football team. They're just running into a better one today in Hanover. First and 10 at the 29-yard line here for the Hornets of Dighton. Throw to the far side. Once again, caught by Hoffman. Once again, a first down as he takes it just in to Hanover territory to the 39-yard line. Pass play at 12 yards. The last one was a 13-yard gain.
And that pass was on a rope. I mean, he threw that on the run, off his, going to his right and off his left foot, and just, that was a really good throw.
I have Hoffman with 7 catches for 84 yards in this game. Again, he's a sophomore, and that's a lot for him because he came in with just 16 catches, but you got to find what works, and he's working today. First and 10 at the 39-yard line, a handover here for Dighton. Twins left. That's the near wide side of the field for Ling. Ling looking over the middle. Pass is intercepted. Zarbaniski just took it away from Hoffman. Like an older brother in the backyard, and he takes it ahead to the 34-yard line.
That was definitely like stealing lunch money to me. Tell you what, he just took it away from him and went down the field. That was a great pass interception right there by your monster back from Hanover.
Interception number 5 for Tyler Ling in this game. The one touchdown, 5 interceptions for Ling today. That's more than he's had the entire season. That's the most impressive stat of the day. He had 4 coming in. He has 5 today.
What's 4-3 touchdowns, and how many touchdowns did he have today?
Just the one.
That's right.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line of Dighton for Hanover. And it's going to be a reverse pass. Stahlbomber throwing downfield for Zarbaniski. And he makes the catch over the top of 2 defenders. He makes the catch right at the 1-yard line.
I didn't say 6-inch line. I mean, they put it where his butt cheeks came down at and anything else compared to anything else, but he just had to sit down right there on his bottom and ended up leaning into the end zone with the football, but we have a Dighton player down.
Trying to see exactly who that is. Oh, it looks like they're working on the leg, and this may be a cramp, hopefully.
Yeah, it's a cramp. That's all it is. They're stretching a leg yet right now. It's a cramp.
The Stahlbomber connecting with Zarbaniski.
Of course, that's your backup quarterback throwing the long pass.
And he was great last week, Coach. I had him 6 of 6 last week for 111 yards.
Well, he's 1 of 1 today.
I thought maybe that pass might have been a little bit underthrown, but it got there over the top of two defenders, the safety in the corner. And Darbiniski just not quite deep enough to get in, but still puts the ball inside of the one. And we'll go ahead and take a timeout with an injury on the field. 48-22, Hanover leading with 1:26 to go. Third quarter, you're listening to Hanover Football on KCLY 100.9.
When you need maintenance service or repair for your vehicle, how can you be sure you're choosing a professional repair facility? One you can count on for excellent service, integrity, and dependability. One way is to visit Floyd's Auto Repair, an auto-valued service center. They offer complete general automotive repairs and represent the best of the best with top quality parts and reliable certified techs. From a simple oil change to engine overhauls, rely on Floyd's Auto Repair, your auto value service center in Hanover.
The Hanover Hospital and Warren Clinic is ready to protect your family's health care needs. From newborns to seniors and everyone in between, they are committed to delivering high quality care. Addressing the health needs ranging from prevention, checkups, and care of illnesses and injury to maternity and other health conditions, they take pride in those they serve. Join Hanover Hospital and Warren Clinic in cheering on the student athletes of the community in their academic and sporting events. They're proud of the Hanover Wildcats.
And welcome back to Newton, Kansas, Fisher Field. It was Dylan Foods who was the injured player for the Dighton Hornets, and he is able to finally walk off under his own power. Hanover has its first and goal, football inside of the one-yard line. I formation, double tight, behind quarterback Will Bruna. He gets it to Carter Bruna. Does he get in? Carter does indeed get in. And for Carter Bruna, it is his third touchdown of the game.
He just put his shoulders down and acted like a Peterbilt, just went on him into touchdown. I'll tell you what, that guy's got four gears and 16 of them, that's for sure.
Three touchdowns for Carter Bruna. 54-22, Hanover, a two-point conversion coming up. 1:12 to go, third quarter. Three eligible on the right side of the formation here for the Wildcats. They run the option here to the strength. It's the pitch to Carter Bruna, and he has to go out and get the pitch that was a little off target. And that's the only thing that really hasn't gone right today for Hanover is their two-point conversion tries. But they do extend their lead 54-22 with 1:12 to go, third quarter. You're listening to Hanover Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
BNW Electric in Hanover is your local electrical specialist, and they're ready to meet your residential or commercial needs. They can handle rewiring jobs, installations, new construction, and more. Rest assured, the work will get done right the first time by professionals who know the job. BNW Electric is ready to handle any project that requires a backhoe. Keep them in mind for all your electrical needs and backhoe service. BNW Electric, proud fans and huge supporters of the Hanover Wildcats.
Bruna Implement, your local Case IH dealer, is excited about the success of the area's high school athletes as they wind down the season. Watching them become not only better athletes, but better young men is the most rewarding thing to see. The love they have for the game, the commitment to the team, and the pride in their schools shows in what they bring to the field. Congratulations to all the area high school teams making it to the postseason playoffs. Bruna Implement, your Case IH dealer, is extremely proud of you.
And the kickoff taken by Hoffman. Hoffman up the near side of the field. And he gets taken down to the 22-yard line. Several stoppers in there for Hanover. Ryan Lupin. And also Pete Peters in on the stop for the Wildcats. 105 to go here, third quarter, 54-22, Hanover with the advantage. K-State and Baylor still tied at 14 early on in the third quarter.
Here come your subs again for Hanover. Dittmer's in there at the nose guard. Stoes is on the defensive end. Fritz is still in there on the other defensive end, so Stoes is in for Clip.
Ling with five interceptions in the game. Rolls to his right, wants to pass on first down. As a receiver open, he fumbled the football. It's still in play. Are they going to say that it went? He was out. Are they going to say he was out when he fumbled it in, Coach? I thought
he was out, but they looked like they tipped the ball back in. But on top of that, the ball could have went out and then been tipped back in because, you know, the sideline is narrower than the regular sideline. So
maybe it threw me off a little.
Well, he stepped out of bounds, and he must have fumbled it out of bounds at that time, and they tried to tip back in to make it look right, but.
All right, so it is first and 10 of the pass play of 15 yards. First and 10 of the 37-yard line, their own 37. Pass play over the middle. Hoffman makes the catch, takes it into Hanover territory. Dietrich slows his progress there, and his forward progress stopped at the 37.
Yeah, the referee almost caught the pass on that one. He was right there where it happened, so luckily he stepped out. He stepped sideways, and the ball was able to be caught. That was a nice pass play by Ling. I mean, Ling's throwing some really nice plays, and receivers are just there, and it's just, you know, he just doesn't have enough personnel around him to help him out.
Second and four, 37-yard line here for Dighton. 37-yard line of Hanover. Snap, swing pass here near side, caught by Foos. Working his way inside of the 30-yard line, finally caught by Stahlbaumer. So Foos is good and back in the game. Cramp injury like we thought earlier.
Yeah, I always thought that was an interesting play. He caught the ball on the left side in the flat, runs about 5 yards, does a spin move on nobody, and then he gets tackled after he makes 3 more yards. So,
pass play at 10 yards, first and 10 of the 27-yard line. Final play of the third quarter coming up here. Trips right, swing pass over to Foos, this time to the right side. Foos gets hit hard by Dietrich and taken out by him, taken out of bounds, and then a flag coming. Why is it? Did they say he was too aggressive after he went out, or? I don't know about that.
Well, Foos is fighting back, too. Yeah. I mean, it was just leverage on leverage there. I don't know whether they're going to call that or not.
Yeah, I guess I shouldn't jump to conclusions. I'll see what call is. And Matt Hoyer not pleased with it, talking with the official close to him. They're going to call a personal foul on that. I just didn't see it, and neither did Matt Hoyer.
I mean, Foos was still applying pressure. Dietrich's going to be they're still upright the whole time away. It wasn't like anybody threw anybody at the ground either, so I don't know for sure what was going on there.
He just basically helped take him out of bounds.
Yeah.
And you are confused as a player because of the lines on the field. So.
And leverage. I mean, there's a lot of leverage there. You know, Dietrich was protecting himself and Foos at the same time. Foos was just going to run trying to get some more extra yards.
So they're just going to continue on here. We're going to start the fourth quarter. There's no stoppage. Here's a throw here to the near side, caught by Hoffman, and it was first and 10 at the 11-yard line. That ball taken inside of the 11.
I don't know what they're doing, Trent, because the clock's been stopped at 12 minutes here for a long time.
Well, it stopped on that final play. There was the penalty, and then they just let him run that.
They can't get into a quarter or a game on a penalty. That's what it was. That was the penalty, so they had to continue on into the fourth quarter.
54-22 after three. Hanover on top of Dighton. You're listening to Hanover Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
It's not too early to book your holiday party, so make out your guest list and set the date. Landau Lanes is the perfect place for your holiday party this year. Their conference center can accommodate small and large groups, whether it's a family get-together or a business event. You provide the guests and the party atmosphere. Landau Lanes will provide the venue and delicious food and drinks that you'll need for a fantastic party. Don't be naughty. Book your holiday party now at Landau Lanes in Marysville.
one field at a time. It's the promise that started it all back in 1946 and is still true today for Lewis Hybrids. From innovative products to their field-by-field placement decisions and replant program, you get more than just seed. You get personalized service that can help you reach your profit potential. Lewis Hybrids and Shaley Seed consider it a privilege to be your partner for success, one field at a time. Visit lewishybrids.com or contact your local Lewis dealer, Roger Shaley of Hanover, by calling 713-2336.
So it's second and six here for Dighton as we welcome you back. Second and six at the 7-yard line of Hanover. They can still pick up a first down. Dighton now going left to right, west to east as we view it, through the first play of the fourth quarter. And it is Hanover up 54-22. A throw over the middle of the pass is going to be overshot to David Kramer. There's a little bit too much on that. Couldn't catch up with that pass from quarterback Tyler Lane. They have not, talking about Dighton, Dighton has not ran the football this entire second half. And they ran pretty decent in the first half. Not great,
pretty balanced.
Better than Hanover did. Item with 17 rushing attempts in the first half. They have none here in the second half. But now third and six at the 7-yard line here for the Dighton Hornets. Trips right, single receiver left-hand side of the formation. Low snap, and Tyler Ling has trouble with it, just has to fall back on top of it. Yardage loss. Carlos Emanuel makes sure that he doesn't get it and go. Loss of three.
Yeah, that was all on Ling that time. He just mishandled it, and that could be fatigue. Could be fatigue right now with the heat stuff, and he's been in there defensively and offensively the whole game, and it's the fourth quarter, and they're not used to playing a full game with the 8-man schedule they played, so this could be fatigue.
And I get it. Dighton is behind by a lot. That's why they're passing all the time, but they might try to run it here in the red zone. So now fourth and 10 at the 11-yard line here for Dighton. Ling, rolling right, makes the throw. The pass is caught, but not enough for a first down. It was caught by Hoffman. He needed to get down to the 1-yard line. He did not. He got to about the 2 or 3, so it should be a change of possession. And it is. It's a change of possession. Exactly where they marked him down at. Looks like it's at the 3-yard line. It is, the 3-yard line.
That's where the mark is on the 8-man marked out football field, but not the 11-man football field.
10 catches for Dalton Hoffman. He came in with 16 catches. So they turn it over on down at the 3-yard line. So Carter Bruna getting the call on first down. He takes the football out to the 10-yard line, gain of 7.
Why not? He had a little dose of Dietrich on the way down on the last possession. Let's have a little dose of Carter Bruna this time. The thunder's going this time, the lightning last time.
7-yard gain on the play for Carter Bruna. Hanover gets back the football. Up 54-22 with 10:48 left. Hanover and White going right to left here in this fourth and final quarter. Dietrich, the single receiver on the left side. He has 4 touchdowns today. Carter Bruna with 3. He gets the handoff. Not a touchdown there, but he does get close to the first down. Takes it across the 10-yard line to the 12. And it looks like he'll be about a yard short.
Yeah, that's another good guard play there. Interrupts the guard. There's also a timeout by the ref, by the official. I think they're going to put a measurement on this one, even, looks like. But that was just a good up the center of the field run by Carter Bruna and his line blocking. And they're just trying to get themselves off of the back of the end zone right now to give them some room to operate.
This is the first of 2 state championships today here in Newton. The second one will be between Osborne and St. Francis. Osborne is 12-0 and St. Francis 11-0. So, Hanover just short of the first down, so it's 3rd and 1 with the football at the 12-yard line. See, even the scoreboard operator gets confused every once in a while. He has a 22 up there, but it's actually the 12.
Yep.
I'm not going to gleefully brag or anything because I've been tripped up 1 or 2 times. And it's a 100-yard field, and they've had to remark it in places to show that it's an 80-yard field. And the quarterback keeping the football, and he'll take it across the 15, Will Bruna to the 16-yard line, and that is good enough for a first down.
That tackle was done by Tyler Ling there. Like I said, he's playing both ways right now, trying to bring his troops, all his troops up here, and it's just a tough time to play both ways.
So first and 10 at the 16-yard line here for Hanover. 10:08 to go in the football game. Hanover is 10 minutes away from their fourth state championship, their first since 2009. They lead 54-22. Bruna taking it off the right side. Look at Carter Bruna go 30, 40, slowing down, waiting for some contact there. He knew it was coming inside of the 30-yard line. And that was finally the guy he ran over earlier, Blair Hoffman, who caught up with him.
Yep. Peterbilt was loose, but he was shifting gears. He's as high as he can go, but he slowed down, but he sure picked up a lot of yardage that time. Old Thunder did on that one.
36 yards on that run for Carter Bruna.
He's been playing both ways a little bit today, too. He's playing a little bit of gas, maybe in the old diesel tank.
62 yards rushing on six carries for him. First and 10 at the Dighton 28-yard line. The give to Carter Bruna again. Starts left. Big hole up the middle. Now he's working his way to the right. Breaking tackles. Gets drugged down just inside of the 10-yard line.
And the only place you could tackle him is low. And that's what they have to do. They have to grab his ankles, do that. They're getting a big dose. And this is just showing the fatigue that Dighton has had, because the line right now for Hanover just blowing them off the line. And just blowing them out of the trenches. You think it was World War II out there, just dropping grenades and letting them blow. That's just amazing.
So now first down and goal. Football just inside of the 10-yard line. Single receiver right side, it's Carter Bruna. He does it all. Dietrich, the single setback this time. And now Dietrich getting a try here, and he gets ridden down by Isaac Torson. Short gain on the play for Kevin Dietrich. Dietrich takes it down to the 6.
Torson's a defensive end. He just crashed down that time, and lucky he did crash down, because there's a big hole there for Dietrich to go on through and make another cut. Hanover's knocked on the door again.
Just inside of 9 minutes to go here in the football game. Hanover up big, 54-22, looking for more. On their way to their fourth state championship. Again, Bruna, Carter out to the right side of the formation. Dietrich, the single setback. Snap. Fake to the back, and Bruna keeping it. And Bruna trying to run it off the right side, and he won't get in, but gets close to the goal line. He'll mark down at the 2 or 1 yard line. Looks like he gets marked down at the 1.
Yeah, he stumbled around there for a little bit, but he kept his hand on the back of his Dietrich that time. He just followed Dietrich up in the middle of the hole there, kept his hand on the back of him, and just kept his balance, and able to pick up 2 or 3 yards that way.
So he gets down to the 1 yard line. Gain of 5 on that carry. Third and goal at the 1 yard line. 8 minutes to play in the game. Ball on that far hash. Carter Bruna, single setback. They feed him, and Carter Bruna, nobody wanted a piece of him. He goes in for the 1 yard score, and now Bruna matches Dietrich with 4 touchdowns. Carter Bruna, 4 touchdowns on the ground in this game.
Yeah, they just gave it to the Peterbilt and let him go, take him on through and cause a hole. And hey, he's a load, 210-pound sophomore. He's just a load, and they're just trying to arm tackle. You cannot arm tackle. The only way they brought him down the last 2 times is just hit him below the knees, around the ankles, and just yell timber.
60-22, the lead for Hanover. Going for 2 here, play fake. Here's a throw to Cole Horst. He makes the catch, and Hanover successful there on that 2-point try. Cohorst, Cade Cohorst with a 2-point reception catch, and that makes the score 62-22. Again, with 7:49 to play in the game. Hanover rolling right now in the state championship. You're listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.
Jones Trash Service provides residential and commercial waste pickup in Washington County. Their service is affordable, dependable, and professional. Jones Trash Service also offers roll-off containers to support your special projects. Whether it's renovation, cleanup, roof replacement, or yard clearing, they'll deliver the containers to you when you need it and remove it when your job is complete. Contact them for quotes for home or business trash service if you're not already on their route. Jones Trash Service of Washington.
Innovation. It doesn't always come easy, but it's always worth the struggle. We at Blue Valley Telecommunications understand how important innovation is to technology. As we look back on the past 60 years, we see how we've transformed telephone service through cables strung on fence posts to telephone, TV, and even high-speed internet over state-of-the-art fiber optic cables. As your technology provider, we're proud to have served you for the past 60 years and look forward to continuing to do that for years to come.
Ooh, and to kick off here, Dylan Foos just gets blown up, as the first to meet him was Lucas Dittmer.
Yeah, that was not a good guy to stand up and try to get hit by, because well, we got the Peterbilt in the game, now we got the Kenworth coming on down the field too, because he just mowed him over.
There you go. 62-22 our score, and Dighton starting back at their 8-yard line, 7:41 to go here in this game.
Lewis is coming in right now. He's limping a little bit too, so Dighton kind of getting banged up a little bit here, and Hanover's looking pretty fresh because they got the subs in again.
The drive for Hanover, 8 plays, 77 yards, 3:16 the time. Carter Bruna, his 4th touchdown run, a 1-yarder, and then Cohorse, the two-point conversion catch, to make it 62-22 where we stand right now. Ling throws it out to the far side, intercepted, a pick six. There's your state championship. That's the exclamation point. The defense finishes this game. Dietrich, that is interception number 6, and that one wins it for Hanover.
I mean, I'm just flabbergasted by that play. Ling just steps back in the corner, pops there, another fly pass, and Dietrich just jumped the route so fast, and so big, nobody had a chance. Everybody just stood and watched him go into the end zone. That's an unbelievable play.
So a pick six to end it. Kevin Dietrich, that is his 5th touchdown of the day. 2 touchdown runs, 2 touchdown catches, and why not end it with a pick six? Both sides of the ball were brilliant today for Hanover. That is state championship number 4 to match Dietrich's jersey number. 68-22 the final. Hanover defeats Dighton in the state championship game. Division 2 8-man here in Newton postgame next on KCLY 100.9.
For any concrete project you need for a residential driveway, basement, patio, or curb, you can count on Midwest Products to handle it. At every level of the job, you'll find a dedicated, skilled crew prepared to deliver a professional job. With state-approved plants in Hanover, Clay Center, Lynn, and Washington, they can meet the needs of residential, commercial, or farm-related projects. For other ready-mix concrete work, give Midwest Products a call at 800-371-2252.
Hey everyone, please head on up to the gun show at the Marysville, Kansas National Guard Armory on Saturday, November 19th from 9 till 5 and Sunday the 20th from 9 till 3. Admission is just $5 and kids 12 and under get in free with an adult. All the proceeds go to benefit American Heritage Girls Troop and Trail Life USA Troop for Boys, both of Marysville. If you're an interested dealer or vendor, please contact Buster Smiths for more details at 785-799-3519.
What did you get your wife for her birthday?
I got her some Radio Mall certificates.
My wife loves the KCLY Radio Mall. It saves us quite a bit of money.
I know. I'm treating her to a new outfit and a manicure. Then she can take me to dinner, and after that, pick up the new truck accessories I want.
Wait, I thought the certificates were for her birthday.
She'll be too shocked that I even remembered. She won't mind sharing.
Get 10, 20, and even 50% off food, clothing, and entertainment from a variety of businesses on the KCLY Radio Mall. Check online for the updated inventory.
Are you hunting for a great internet value? Check out Twin Valley Pulse. Don't settle for slow internet. This season, set your sights on the fastest internet available. Get Pulse Gig Internet with speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second. It handles multiple devices, streaming services, online gaming, and much more.
Get more bang for your buck with Twin Valley's Pulse Internet service. Call 800-515-3311 today for Twin Valley Pulse Internet. All your devices, one superior connection.
If you're inspired to throw the best party for a friend, an anniversary, dinner for your employees, or any other special occasion that calls for delicious food, Ricky's Cafe in Hanover has you covered. They offer catering services in the entire KCLY listing area with competitive prices. Give them a call and see what's on the menu for your big event. Catering is a solution for feeding large groups of people, and Ricky's Cafe knows how to make mouths water. Ricky's Cafe in Hanover, catering to all your celebrations.
At SAP Brothers, they pride themselves on the high level of service they provide and their ability to meet their customers' special fueling needs. From bulk gasoline and diesel to propane and oil delivery, SAP Brothers is a fuel source to residents and businesses alike in Marshall and Washington counties. They can deliver a variety of bulk fuels to where you need it, at your home or out in the field. Contact them for a competitive fuel quote. Call their Hanover office at 337-2446.
Hey, welcome back to the postgame show here on KCLY. Hanover gets it done. They win 68-22 over Dighton. And that is the fourth state championship in school history for Hanover. Their first since 2009, so state championships in 79, 2008, 2009, and now 2016. Hanover, what a way to end the game as they win it. Mercy rule, Dighton with a pick six from Kevin Dietrich. And Dietrich, a huge game, five touchdowns for him in the game. And just looking back and go over who scored the touchdowns for Hanover, I could go back to the second half, didn't really give that summary yet. Hanover increased their lead to 42-14 at the 10:47 mark of the third quarter. Dietrich, an 8-yard run. Bruna added a 2-point conversion on a catch. And then with 2:45 to go in the third quarter, Dietrich, a 9-yard run, made it 48-22. Bruna then with 1:12 to go in the third quarter, a 1-yard run. And then Bruna added another 1-yard run. That was with 7:49 to go in the football game. That made it 62-22. And then the final one, touchdown, came on the pick six. That made it 68-22. To end the game at the 7:35 mark because of the mercy rule. Allen, Kansas State, that's some good, a lot of good news coming our way. K-State just moved ahead 28-14 at Baylor. Great job, Kansas State.
It's a good day to be a Wildcat.
And no doubt.
Hanover or K-State.
No doubt about it. And just looking back, touchdowns the whole four Hanover in this game. And Dietrich had five of them. He had, and this is the whole game, 25-yard catch, also a 7-yard reception in the first half. In the second half, the 8-yard run, the 9-yard run, and the pick six. You also had Bruna. Bruna with three touchdowns. He had a 3-yard run in the first half, or actually, correction, he had four touchdowns. He had 2 3-yard runs in the first half. He had 2 1-yard runs in the second half. So 4 total touchdowns for Carter Bruna. You had Fritchie with a 13-yard touchdown reception in the first half. That was a big one at the time. It was a tie game at the time, and that came on a 4th-and-7 play. And that is it as far as the touchdowns in the game for Hanover. Individual and team stats, Hanover unofficially 430 yards of total offense, 162 on the ground, 268 through the air. I had Will Bruna unofficially 13 of 18 throwing the football, 235 yards passing, 3 touchdowns, 2 interceptions in the game. Carter Bruna, the leading ground gainer, 7 carries, 81 yards, go along with all those touchdowns. Kevin Dietrich, 6 carries, 35 yards. Will Bruna, 11 carries for 51 yards. And Carter Bruna with 4 touchdown runs. Dietrich, 2 touchdown runs. Receiving wide, Kevin Dietrich, 2 catches, 86 yards, including 2 touchdowns. And I cheated him. He actually had 7 catches for 93 yards and 2 touchdowns. Stahlbomber, 5 catches for 26 yards. Darbiniski, 3 catches for 69 yards. He had Fritchie, the 1 touchdown catch. Atkins, the catch of 46 yards, and Zavatrisky, the catch, 1 catch of 20 yards in the game. Dighton, unofficially, I had Tyler Ling, 24 of 39, 246 yards passing, 1 touchdown, but 5 interceptions in the game. Folks, he only had 4 the whole year. No, correction, he had 6 interceptions, 6 interceptions in the game. I mean, so many, it blew my mind.
Yeah.
4 all year, 6th in this state championship game. What a job by the Hanover defense. Tyler Lang led the team in rushing. They attempted no rushing attempts in the second half. He led the way with 9 carries for 39 yards. His favorite passing target, Dalton Hoffman, 10 catches for 102 yards. Dylan Foos had 7 catches for 93 yards. Those were the top targets in the game. I had Dighton with 8 penalties, 5 of those in the second half. Hanover, just 4 penalties in the game. The big story, though, was the turnovers, 7 total turnovers for Dighton. Again, I knew that they had 4 interceptions. Unofficially, I heard they had 5 total turnovers coming into today. Way over their season average per game today without question. They had more than their whole season today turning over the football. It's quite remarkable. Hanover just 2 turnovers today. Plus 5, they win that battle.
Well, like we talked about the first game, you know, their defense being their best offense and stuff, and it's amazing. What I thought was interesting is how Hanover ended the season here and how they subbed in these kids, just the sophomores they brought in, the juniors they brought in. You know, we talk about Dietrich being a junior, but Fritzy being a senior. But Fritzy, I thought today had a really good game defensively, offensively, and how he just turned things around. But you talk about they're bringing back Dietrich, they're bringing back Atkins, they're bringing back these juniors and sophomores, Stahlbomber, these guys that have made big plays today, but just led and started off this group of seniors have started something that they could carry on for the next 2 or 3, 4 years. Also, I think this is a really good scene right here looking in here because they're changing times in the games here. Just to see the Hanover fans out there, the Dighton fans out there congratulating their two teams. And it was a well-fought game, and I just thought everything came together really well for Hanover.
Well, and just you have a lot of relation here. We spent a lot of time up here with the folks that we've gotten to know over the last several weeks and just telling us how 5 of the Dietrichs and Brunas, if I have that right, are our first cousins. So just, and last week at Stahlbomber and Kohlhorst, so just a lot of relation. You have the senior class, Dacey Hagedorn, Adam Fritchie, Will Bruna, Adam Zarbaniski, Jesse Stowes, Trevor Clift, Lucas Dittmer. Their final game, 3 consecutive state championships for that class of seniors, or I should say 3 state championship appearances for the state championship here in their senior season. Just tremendous accomplishments. They had been runners-up the last 2 years in Division One, losing to Central Plain 3 years ago, I should say, and then last year to Spearville. So it's just quite an accomplishment by that group.
Yeah, I mean, they were sophomores when they started appearing in state. Now they're seniors. And they didn't want to pass it on to their sophomores and just keep it going. Hanover's got a really good group coming back. You know, I see them making some noise next year. In fact, not just not one and done. This is a team and a program that continue on to get better.
So again, that was actually 2 years ago they lost to Central Plains in Division One, did Hanover, and then last year to Spearville. State champions here in Division Two 8-man as they win today the final 68-22, mercy rule in effect at the 7:35 mark of the fourth quarter. So again, your final 68-22, Hanover champions in 8-man Division Two. One more 8-man game coming up. It'll be the Division One championship game. That will kick off at 3:30. And it features undefeated Osborne 12-0 against St. Francis undefeated at 11-0 right here at Fisher Field in Newton. It's been great working with Bernie Fancella. Thanks to you for all your work. Coach Klein, appreciate you. We're both from Abilene, and it's a little bit of a trip to go up to Hanover, so I appreciate your time and going up there with me to cover all these great games and meet all these great people.
Not a problem. I tell you, it's just good to see other parts of the state and basically kind of going home to the old league, so to speak, and seeing some old friends and seeing how things progress around the state. Like I said, Dighton being NWKL, seeing the two leagues that I've coached in come together in a state championship game is amazing. But, you know, last 2 weeks just covered Hanover has been a really good trip for me to go and to also be with you, Trent. You do a great job.
Thank you much, Coach. You as well. That'll do it for me, Trent Sanchez. Hanover wins the state championship. Your final 68-22 here from Newton. Thanks for listening to Hanover State Championship Football on KCLY 100.9.